Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Nobody Likes Onion Show. I have two guests in my studio today who are going to probably try to ruin this introduction. But I'm looking at them, and now they're not. And what they're thinking is, we made you look so stupid by ruining your introduction without even doing anything. What we did was say we were going to ruin your introduction, and then you had to talk about it. So now, who's the fucking dumbass? Well, the joke's on me, I guess. I'm the dumbass. Welcome to the show, everybody. I'm the guy that brought you Siegfried and Roy when people only knew who Roy was. And I teamed them up together outside that Denny's on Route 66 back in Oklahoma City. Hi. Lots of commotion.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Wow.
Welcome to the Nobody Likes Onions podcast.
My name is George. Commotion in the studio today. We have George White here.
Did you blank on his name?
No, he started acting weird and it caught me for a loop.
His little Hello Kitty move?
No, yeah, what was that, George? Explain yourself.
I lived in Korea for 7 years and that's what they do.
Okay, they don't. Tyler Jolley is also here, America's Mustache. Do you ever thought about coming up with a slogan like that? America's Mustache or Sinbad's opener?
Everyone kind of bugs me about it. And
people do.
Yeah, I get a lot of heat.
They come up down the street and they're always like,
"You should do more mustache jokes.
You should talk about it."
Yeah, do a sticker that's just a mustache, but then your name's in it. And I'm like, no.
You're killing it though. I saw you perform at Jimmy Kimmel's Comedy Club the other night. You were great.
Thank you. Thank you.
Appreciate that. I saw another friend of ours perform there, and I had to leave before the headliner, which was who?
Josh Blue.
Now, I would, as much as I love to see a man flop around on stage, I had to go.
Yeah.
Well, I was driving down, this is an embarrassing but true story, and I was going to save it for...
He's a great comic, though.
Josh Blue?
Yeah, he had some great stuff.
I'm making a horrible joke.
Yeah, no, yeah, that's why I didn't
hit. To mask my own...
It didn't hit. Security.
Don't point out when my jokes don't hit, just for the future. Like we will edit. Don't worry, we got it. We covered it. Good, good, good. In post, let me get some room tone. Good.
They
got it.
It was a weird part about that show. Like I noticed, so I didn't know that he used to write for Ron White.
Yeah.
And during
I don't know if he actually wrote.
One arm's okay.
Yeah.
But they were
two of them didn't hit.
They were complaining about Ron White wanting to hang out.
Who was?
I mean, I don't. People.
Who was complaining? You can't bring up. You can't talk some shit. You know.
I'm not talking shit. I just.
I'm glad you brought it up.
No, it wasn't like a complaint. It was just like Ron wants to hang out tonight because Ron likes to party. Everyone knows Ron drinks. Ron fucking goes hard in the paint when he's in Vegas. And they were just like, I don't want to.
He probably gets regular drugs. He probably doesn't huff paint.
Hard in the paint.
Oh, sorry.
It's a basketball term.
Yeah, no, I know. I was making it. I do comedy. Guys, welcome to the show. Nobody likes onions. We're all drinking up. What is everybody? You guys have Coke?
Yes, some Jim and Coke.
Where did you stop? By the way, what gas station in 1928 did you stop by to get Coca-Cola in a glass bottle? Or is that Mexican Coke?
It's Mexican Coke.
Oh, okay. Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
They only make it in bottles.
Yeah. And it's, regular Coke too. Just isn't that good anymore.
Well, this is made with real sugar. That other shit.
No, regular Coke is garbage.
Yeah. I was a big Pepsi drinker until I started, drinking Mexican
Coke. You know what? Alex Kool-Aid Ansel. And before we get started on this show, which I'm sure will be very fine, Merry Christmas to you and yours.
Didn't want to miss that.
No, I just have to get
you
our
can't
lawyers.
Have people be like, He didn't fucking say Merry Christmas.
He said Merry Christmas, not Happy Holidays.
Hold on.
Let's do another one.
Yeah.
Happy Holidays to you and yours.
There we go. You don't want anyone being like, boom. And they do like a voiceover of you saying Merry Christmas. And they're like, I got you, Patrick Melton. I made you say Merry Christmas.
Well, now you just did the voiceover for him. Fuck. We'll edit all this out.
I'm helping people.
Should we start again?
Play the music again. There we go. No.
I have to get this out of the way before we go on, because if you haven't joined the overdose since this show will probably come out in a few days. If you're watching it live, you're welcome. But if you haven't joined the overdose and seen Alex Kool-Aid Ansel get topless with two other guests, you're really missing out.
Now that makes sense.
We have a new correspondent for the show named Krem Waldorf. And we also have Alex Kool-Aid Ansel and Adam Rodriguez. Sorry, Adam Gomez. I always fuck it up.
Gutierrez.
Perez? What is it?
Gutierrez.
Perez Hilton? He was on the show. Although I feel bad for Adam because he's really funny and he was really just a shoe print in the side of the room that show, because it was all about Kool-Aid and Waldorf.
All three of them were on the same show?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
It was a goddamn circus.
There's no room in here.
4.5 hours of just...
You put 2+. I didn't know it was 4+.
Yeah, to have like...
2+ for the show. Then there's like an after show and a pre-show where we pat Waldeck down.
Waldorf.
We patted Waldeck down. He left Waldorf. He came in Waldeck. But join the overdose, $10 a month. That's how I pay my bills and also my bookies. So please give money to that. Now that that's out of the way.
Big gambling problem? like the horses, huh?
I will tell you this. I am in need of some explanation, because we got nowhere with it last night, about what's happening in the comedy community in Las Vegas.
Everyone's losing their fucking minds.
There's a rapist on the loose.
Yeah.
That's 10 years old.
This Corey guy?
Who's a Corey?
Isn't this Corey Sweeney? Am I not supposed to say that out loud? Is Corey Sweeney not a rapist? Call in.
I'm not sure. I read what you read.
We read the post yesterday. There was a comic from LA named Natasha Lyonne. I don't know. What was her name? Do you know this girl?
The one from Canada?
You guys not plugged into this group? Because it's the most entertaining thing I've ever seen in my life.
Stanton.
Elizabeth Stanton.
Yeah, from Lizzie Canada. Stanton. Vancouver. Yeah.
Apparently she called a black comic the N-word.
Yes.
But used the word. I can't afford to edit it again. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nigger? You say it.
Nigger?
Hold on. Let's get it clean.
Let's get a clean clip.
Can you zoom in on him?
Yeah, hold on one second.
Get all just on his lips. Don't let your lips all get all fucked up by the microphone.
Look right at the camera. We're going to need you to do it clean.
3, 2, 1.
Man, you can't command a black person to say nigger on command.
Wow. I think we all just got...
All right, so there's a word out there. I'm not saying which word. You say it at will.
I'm
3, 2, 1.
All right. Well, I guess we've all learned our fucking lesson. So he got us.
I didn't know that was a rule.
There's accusations that this guy tried to rape a girl at a show last week. There's accusations that this woman kept throwing around the N-bomb at this comic. She's on her Facebook page telling people that's not how it went down.
But she did say, I said a joke to him, but she doesn't say what joke.
Yeah.
She doesn't say the joke.
Said, she just... Do you think it's smart to fuck with me? I perform at the Comedy Store. And I think his comeback was, I don't care where you bomb. Which is one of the best comebacks.
That sounds just like
I've
him.
Ever fucking that's, heard
yeah,
in my
that's
life.
How, yeah.
I don't care where you bomb. I just want to know what's going on. Like, honestly, like deep cut. Like deep real talk. This is like the third person I've heard about rape and child abuse.
Yeah, no, it's hot in Vegas. It's hot.
What is going on?
Hot move. Yeah.
Is this like just closer than Alaska? People come here to get away?
Yeah.
Like all the freaks.
Yeah. No, but honestly, what's going on? And all these comics are still active.
I mean, it's not like we're not vocal.
Well, I
want
to put a stop to it.
We're vocal.
I mean, you're all pretty tight-lipped right now.
I don't know.
I mean, what, do you want me to say who and everything?
I'd like to hear Tyler's list.
You tell me your list, and I'll tell you if I've heard of them.
Well, I could just start naming comics. This will be fun.
Oh, you've been in the game for...
No, but I'm not plugged into the local scene like you guys are. There's some major fucking scandals that have popped off here, and I come back. Like, there are people in this town who hate people that other people revere. You know what I mean?
Who do people revere?
Brant Tobler. People, it's love or hate him. The line.
I think that's just how Tobler is.
What do you mean?
I mean, he's kind of like he's
divisive.
He's hard to befriend, you know. And if he doesn't like you, you know it instantly, you know. So if the people who hate him, he doesn't give a shit.
Somebody said there's a shooting in Vegas that nobody ever talks about either.
Damn,
that is true. We did kind of just let that go.
Yeah.
Any news on the killer?
No, I don't know. I wasn't here.
It's hard to keep up with.
Well, what are you keeping up with? What are you so busy with? I know you have a pig.
I watched the impeachment today. I did that.
Oh, yeah, I didn't.
It was terrible.
What happened?
It was.
Did we lose a press? Did we win?
Yeah, he got impeached.
Well, now it goes to the Senate.
Now
right?
It goes to the Senate where it'll lose.
It'll lose because it has to be 2/3.
But
so.
He's.
What does it mean? What does that mean?
2/3 of the Senate have to vote that he needs to be impeached.
To get kicked out.
So, but he fired. Won't be.
He won't be. It's
two-thirds, all horseshit. I don't know. I was really surprised that it happened today.
Yeah, well, it's because it's Democratic control, so the House.
Yeah.
So it was going to pass, but then once it gets to the Senate, it's done.
But watching it was like watching
what
a
is the
room
thing
full
he's
of
being
comedians.
Impeached for? What do we finally have on him?
The Russia thing?
It wasn't. It was Ukraine.
Ukraine, yeah, the Ukraine calls.
He called the new president of Ukraine and was like, hey, can you look into Biden? And if you don't, I'm going to withhold aid from you.
Here's how insane this whole thing is. Now that they've got him, quote unquote, which they don't, because nothing will come of this.
This is what sucks.
By the time they here's what Democrats suck at. You've tooted your horn and been screaming about him being guilty about shit for so long and producing no evidence to back that up.
Right.
That now that you have him on something, like I didn't even know, like I'm not even aware this is going down. Mm-hmm. You know, because I've been at rollerblade practice.
Oh, over Crystal Palace?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, but don't tell people we're in practice. We'll edit it. no, I'm afraid of a real Tanya Harding situation.
Is she there?
No, someone's going to hit him in the leg with a
She'll have a dumb stick. Boyfriend who hires me.
That guy.
She'll be plausibly deniable.
I've
seen it a million times.
That guy is my favorite person in the skating world.
Tanya Harding?
No, the guy that's like, no, I'm like really deep FBI, CIA stuff. I can't really talk
about it. Oh, the dude in the movie. Like, the dude who plays him in the movie.
No, the real, like at the end of the movie, they show the real interview with the guy.
Right.
And that guy is fucking crazy. They're like, no, you're not. Like, we've looked into you. You're not a part of any of that. And he goes, no, that's just what you think, but I am.
I didn't
and you're
know.
Like, no, you're not. It's
I didn't
amazing.
Know that Tanya Harding was Allison Janney's daughter.
That's yeah, big
that
big,
was
big switch.
A really
big,
big
surprise.
Plot twist for me.
You're like M Night shit my pants.
I was like, and I went on a Reddit immediately and I was like, nobody told me that Allison Janney's daughter is Tanya Harding. They were like, spilt milk, baby.
Is that the chick who was in
It's a line from the movie that didn't go over well unless you've seen the movie, and probably not even then.
I don't even know who you're talking
I didn't
about.
Know that was in the movie. I saw it, I liked it.
It was a great film. The point is, stop raping. Stop Trump 2020.
That's what that people have been waiting to hear.
What?
It's just someone to say, stop raping.
No, but like, what is going on? Like, what is happening? Who? I can't even fathom it because I can't wrap my fucking mind around it. Like, what are you doing? I want to know the details about this guy who raped at a club.
Quit,
and who do I have to call?
Quit looking at me. Look at George, too, when you see
who
this
Who do
shit.
I have to call? Well, I feel like when you look at a black guy while you're talking about rape, it feels like you're selling
you're gonna
something.
You're going to lose some fans.
You know what I mean? No, yeah, it just feels wrong. And it's probably really right, if you know what I mean. But it feels
so good.
Super wrong to do. But, like, honestly, I want to know who the person is I have to talk to. This Russell... Crow? What's his name?
That's it. Yeah.
No,
big
what's
comic.
Comedian Russell.
Who's Russell?
Randall.
Randall Thompson.
Randall Thompson?
Robbie. You know the guy
Randall,
I'm looking for?
Randall Thompson got called the N-word.
Randall
yeah,
Robbie.
Yeah, but he's also the guy who's saying this guy raped.
Well, that's not true.
So does he have details?
Probably.
No, he said this guy tried to rape somebody at a show last week.
Oh.
He posted that in the same post.
Sorry.
So I need
I
to know.
I got bored halfway through.
I need to know who... Don't get bored about it while I'm trying to solve a goddamn crime.
Well, get at it.
Who's
Carmen San Diego?
Yeah, but who do I talk to get the facts of the crime? Because I'm asking you who rapes, and you have a list. You have a list you refuse to give up. of rapists.
Look at that face.
Name everybody who's a rapist in this town if you were on rape, if you're against rape.
I hate
George, am I wrong?
No, you're not.
If he's against rape,
then he'll give
he
up the
should
names.
Name up give up the names of the rapes he knows.
Okay, so he said Corey
you're going
Sweeney.
You're going to bed with rapes on your conscience.
He said Corey Sweeney.
With rape on
you're
your
putting
pillow?
Me single? This is just on me.
You'll be in bed with rape on your pillow.
Thank you. It's going to get everywhere. It's not going to come out.
You've got rape on your hands.
You said Corey Sweeney. I don't know about the whole Corey. I know Corey. Or
and
what was his,
has he ever tried to rape you?
He used to rap. Yeah.
Did you forget an E?
What?
He used to rap.
I've seen him rap. I haven't
he raps
seen him rape.
And rapes?
Yeah, he was, I can't remember. Actually, he used to go by a different name.
Rapping raper?
He used to go by a different name.
Rapist rapper?
And then his slogan is, and the only thing missing is the
somebody
E.
Somebody said, first 48 this shit, call. Yeah, that's what I want to know. Who can we get?
On the phone?
I'll fly him here.
What are you talking?
I want to solve a murder. Have you ever seen Serial, dude? Do you know how many downloads I got?
What's Serial, dude?
The podcast. Serial, they solve murder.
He just keeps screaming Serial.
Yeah, no, I'm
Serial, S-E-R-I-A-L. Serial, the podcast. They solve murders.
My favorite.
Like they were like the biggest podcast in 2014. 20.
Big fan, huh?
You know what I'm fucking talking about? You guys have seen... Happy holidays to your dad. You've seen Serial.
No.
They get so many downloads, dude. You've seen Making a Murderer?
I've seen
on
Netflix?
I watched it's, halfway through it.
It's that, but a podcast. Yeah. And if you had a podcast that a lot of people listen to halfway through...
Then you're...
You'd be golden. A fucking millionaire. You're welcome. This is a business seminar. Most nights it's a TED Talk.
Yeah, keep going.
What else do you want to know about business?
Who rapes?
You know what the best year to if you're making a presentation? PowerPoint 2000. Don't go anything past that. They fucked it up.
You're really...
What did they
do? I know about PowerPoint 2002. They moved all the menus. It was fucking insane.
Did they add too many bells and whistles?
No, they took out all the whistles and most of the bells are correct.
Oh my God. Just go back to the way it used to
be. Just a bunch of Liberty Bells.
All right.
Well, MAPA. Make PowerPoint great again.
yeah, that worked. That was exactly, that's MAPA.
That's exactly how it goes. Make America PowerPoint again.
Whenever Tyler's here, we like to talk about our favorite things at Costco. so I want to ask you if you've made any real discoveries at Costco that I need to know about.
Last time, did we talk about the little cookies?
No. First of all, look, you wanted to do this podcast at 11 p.m. If I watch you yawn into your fist one more time, you sack of human garbage. Tell me about him now again that he doesn't leave the house. He's like an old fucking man.
Dude, last time
how
we
bad
were supposed
is it?
To. No, listen,
yeah, we were supposed to do this
6 o'clock. And he's like,
ago.
I don't know, man. Streetlights are on.
The streetlights are on. God forbid we have a municipality that does things.
A municipality?
What the fuck is wrong with
you?
You
had to be home.
The streetlights are on. That means that my fucking ombudsman is doing his job. I don't know.
Dude, that's all I do is edit.
Ombudsman?
Ombudsman.
Is that a representative?
Yeah.
For Henderson?
Sure.
Jeez.
Is that the guy who turns on the streetlights?
No, it's not a name. It's a title.
Like a
district selectman or a city council.
Comptroller.
Budsman?
Comptroller. Ombudsman.
What is that?
Oh, man.
Do they turn
God
the light? Do they
like
turn the streetlights on? That's all I want to know.
Yeah, that's the guy with the app.
He just
every
swipes.
Night. No, he sets an alarm. He never misses it.
Yeah.
If he's in Hawaii, he has to get woken up. Like a different
time. He gets
zone.
Up at 6 o'clock in the
sometimes
afternoon.
Sometimes he gets drunk his and twin, turns them on at 4 p.m. He's
his
fucked.
Twin brother gets up and he's like, it's time to turn the lights on. He's like, I already turned the lights on.
So what was your problem that we couldn't do the podcast Saturday?
Dude, it was...
And now you're yawning into your fist like an old fucking man.
It was
man.
Late. That's what he
date.
Said.
I had a date with my girlfriend.
You had a date with your
they
girlfriend.
They lived together. Yeah. That's bullshit.
Yeah.
You lived together.
Yeah.
And where did you go on this date?
On the couch. We just hung out.
You live together.
You watching Game of Thrones?
At that point, there's no difference in laziness or a date.
Yeah.
You had an appointment to...
It's so funny. No, it's because I wanted to go back home, go to sleep for work.
This better be funny when you set it up like that.
I mean, to work early on Monday.
This better be fire.
Now here I am on a fucking Wednesday.
Yeah, but
at 12
a.m. What is your deal? Like, how old are you again? 48?
First 48, yeah.
Now, how old are you?
39.
And I just turned 40, so I'm older than you.
Yeah.
Like, we...
You look great.
But this is your job.
You look amazing.
I look like a garbage fire.
I wouldn't say you were a day over 39.
Thank you. That means nothing to me.
Thank you.
I am fat.
Yes.
I'm disgusting.
Correct.
Like, if you look at me compared to you...
I don't want to.
Like, I want to put it side by side on the screen so everyone can see. And don't be distracted by the snow.
Hold on. What does that have to do with anything, though?
I'm getting to that.
Okay.
Imagine if I just left it here. Guys, I'm fat. Moving on.
I'm fat. I'm getting to a point. I'm disgusting.
You know, I'm trying to work in a bong hit here, but somebody's been carrying the show the whole time, so they can't pick a bong up.
Yeah, okay, so about raping.
We'll edit that, because that should have gone over better.
It bombed. What it about, didn't hit well.
Dude, I was there. Bro, don't mention it.
I can't help it.
I thought you said podcasts were better at midnight.
You owe me one about not mentioning stuff.
My man's got to take
a
bong
hit. We'll clear that, but you know. What?
I got to take
what was your date?
Black don't crack. He's 63.
What was your date, George?
All right, young date? Man.
Do you guys watch Game of Thrones?
No.
What's going on?
Oh, honestly, I just want to go to sleep
Mass
early.
Mass Singer?
I just want to go to sleep early.
You keep it up on Mass Singer?
It's 8 a.m. in Scotland, and someone is up to buy crap Christmas gifts. Well, send me all a gift card. Everybody, send me a gift card.
That's what they called him?
He's in Scotland?
They said crap Christmas gifts? Or no, did you say crap?
That's somebody watching. They're out shopping for crap Christmas gifts.
He's in Scotland? My brother lives in Ireland.
They said crap, though?
It's a different country.
They're buying someone crap
he just,
gifts?
Yes, had a baby.
In Scotland.
I'm an uncle. Well,
just get better friends, dude. Like, that's all I'm saying.
Anyway, what was your date?
My brother just had a baby yesterday.
What is your problem with going out, though? This is my point.
Dude, are you on the same show we're on?
I'm a fat piece of shit.
All the Coke.
I'm about to smoke a bong. I drink alcohol. I'm fat and lazy. I'm not in health. Do you work out? You probably go to the gym.
Yeah, I haven't been in months, though.
You've seen my weights. It's a joke.
From the 1930s.
Let me tell you something. They're not from the 1930s. They don't have, like, pull pins.
It looks like you ride a big tricycle with the big wheel on front before you work out.
I do. It's out back.
You lift the...
It's called a recumbent bike.
The barbells with the big...
It's not. It's called a penny farthing. Guys, if we're not going to fact check things, this is all for naught. Okay? Like, I just throw out recumbent bicycle. You accept it? No.
You banned me from my phone, and I respect your room.
Here's the point. Why can't you go out? Why are you yawning at 11 p.m.?
Because
Tyler,
I have a
he's
day
pretty
job.
Much dead.
I have a day job.
He's
I teach.
He's married. Day job. Comedy, an afterthought.
Yeah, that's my life.
But look at him.
I'm here.
You see what he has?
Mustache.
A fucking sparkle in his eye. Hope.
You know what
a
you
dream.
Should do? You should create a logo that says Prump, but the M is your mustache.
No.
Yeah.
Because I don't want either
Calm
of those things.
Calm down, P-Town.
Don't say that.
Alex is in the chat. Alex Ansel.
Kool-Aid Ansel.
Gross. Old pancake tits himself. George doesn't go out because he doesn't get booked.
Yeah.
George a map. Like oh, this is getting fucking weird. Oh, my buddy Jake from LA is in the chat. Oh, it's fired up. We're popping off tonight. Happy Christmas, everybody.
Happy
Tell your
Christmas.
Grandchildren
That's what
about us.
Say.
Welcome to the show. If you've just joined us, we're settling an argument between who's the oldest and fattest. I'm winning. But George acts the oldest and fattest. He looks like a guy who needs help carrying his groceries to the car. Like,
excuse me, young man.
Yeah,
I was
you
gonna
do.
Say, you do say young man a lot, I'm sure.
I love it. I love saying young man. It's
actually, do you know
shit.
What you look like? You look like a guy who simultaneously needs help carrying groceries to the car and a guy who carries your groceries to the car.
He looks
you look like that.
Me or him?
Tyler? Him.
Oh, me? Oh, I thought Tyler
I'm
looks like the person
if you
who
agree.
Eats the groceries on the way to the car.
He's not fat. Tyler, are
you
fat?
You look like you tip 50 cents.
No, 3 pennies.
Like you're like, here you go, young man.
Three copper.
I didn't mean
three
for this to turn into a roast battle, but here we go. All right.
3 copper bits.
Tyler's turn. Go.
What is that what we're doing?
Yeah.
I tell him what he looks like. Bagger Vance over
Alex
here.
Alex says, love y'all.
Love y'all.
That means he's leaving?
Yeah. Yeah, Alex, are you leaving or do you want to call in? Because we'd love for you to, if your fingers can dial. Is there an app that, is there an app that makes your keypad larger?
Alexa, give me fat finger keypad.
Oh, was that God. Old person phone that has all the bigger buttons on it?
Oh, yeah, like Homer Simpson had to have in that yeah. one episode.
While he's wearing a muumuu.
And he just gets one of those mercury pigeons to to peck his keyboard.
It almost kills everyone.
Alex just said, I'm going to die soon.
Yeah.
I told him because, no, honestly, last night he was drinking wild cherry Pepsi. Jeez. Which clocks in like 400 grams of sugar per can. I looked at it. It was 53 grams of sugar per can. That's bananas.
Was
dude.
He drinking out of 2 liter?
It was like 130% of your daily recommended allowance of sugar per can. There were tall boys. I didn't even know Pepsi made tall boys.
It was a tall boy can of...
of wild cherry Pepsi. I shit you
it
not.
It seems like something you'd only get at like the airport. You know, like just like a weird thing.
What if you're the guy who goes specifically to pay airport prices for wild cherry Pepsi? Like, yeah, I want a can of wild cherry Pepsi, but I want to pay $7.80 for it.
I don't want 12 ounces. I need more than 12 ounces.
Oh, my God. Yeah, maybe that was it. I don't know.
I don't want to look weird drinking it.
Dewar's is a shit whiskey. It basically the dregs and scrapings of a whiskey barrel. Fuck me. This is the Scottish guy.
Nah,
so
bitch. It's white label, so...
Yeah, it is white label, Mikey. So
get out of here.
Hey, tell him what you paid for it. Maybe
Mikey,
that'll win the argument.
I got that Dewar's for $17 a bottle. Show him the size of it, George.
It's so
big. It's fucking massive.
It's the size of my head.
It's a big bottle.
Look at that. Take that,
Mikey.
And
I got that for $17. Oh, yeah. Alex broke up with his girlfriend today.
I'm sorry, man.
I wish we had this show. He was so happy last night. He wasn't drinking.
Yeah.
I put an 18-pack of beers in front of him that I bought for him, and he wouldn't drink them. He's like, I'm not drinking. And then I see today he posts AirPods for sale that he got for his girlfriend for Christmas because she dumped him.
Stupid. How much are they? Kool-Aid, how much are they?
They're first gen, so don't do it.
never mind. Why would you buy first gen?
Well, that's why she dumped you, you cheap son of a bitch.
Because they're on sale on Amazon, that's why.
First gen AirPods, Kool-Aid, though, how much sack are they? Of shit. The new ones came out like in March.
No, yeah, but they're like an extra $50.
Yeah, that's why they were on sale, so you got them on the cheap.
Alex, do you want to come over and booze with us? You can tap George.
He doesn't have a car. How's he going to get here?
Wow. I'll Uber him here, and I'll pay for it.
Oh, do it.
And guess what? I'll pay for them Uber to go XL? Through any drive-thru of your choice, Alex. We probably have a fan them. That'll do it for you.
All of them on the
but
way
But you have
here.
To bring food for us, too.
Yeah, what do you want? What are you craving?
I mean, it's up to him if he's going to come.
What are you Wes craving?
I'll figure it out.
Wendy's?
Have you had the Popeyes chicken sandwich everybody's talking about.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We you? Talked about that on our show.
Yeah, we did?
Yeah.
Because I'm obsessed with it.
Yeah, you said it was great.
I've been getting
it's good.
Because I'm on no carbs.
What's the wait time?
Now.
When I get on the scale, I usually know within 2 minutes.
It takes that long to calculate. For
what do you think the turnover rate is?
Oh, no. I've noticed they're done. They're done. Oh, Alex said I'm drinking tonight. I ball hard for wild cherry Pepsi. Well, that's fucking weird. She wanted them. You gave her the AirPods? He said he'll come. He's coming.
All right. How's he getting
I
here?
Don't know why. I don't know why.
Is he Chris
I feel
walking?
Like he shouldn't be alone tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alex. There's so many people live in that house. He's fine.
Yeah.
No, but one of them.
One of them isn't allowed near this elementary school.
You talking about Waldorf?
No.
Krim Waldorf? I said he was the best thing since Krim Hemsworth. last night's show was great.
Does that pick up when I set that down?
Yeah.
It does a little bit. I think it's the mic arms.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you know, I just moved that and I think it's not fastened on right. No, yours is good. These mics are $400 mics. These are good mics.
Oh, okay.
But I gave him the, you know.
I got the shit one.
Oh, you got the shit, yeah. What is the omnidirectional one?
You chose to
what is
sit
this?
There.
It unsure?
Yeah.
It was the nice chair.
Alex said, I'm glad Patrick's making this podcast funny. No, you know what it is. Like when I'm on their show, they make it funny. When they're on my show,
we're just
nobody
letting you
does.
Lead. We're just letting you lead, man.
Yeah, no. This
I'd
is
rather
house.
You lead it. I haven't prepared anything.
You're stupid.
I have
on.
One note on my things that says LV comedy is rape town. I wish I was lying to you. That's exactly what the note says. Like, I'm honestly thinking about moving. It's depressing. I was thinking about going to Pahrump where rape is legal.
If you pay for it, it's not rape.
Now you got this dope home studio setup with Suge Knight on the wall.
This came with the house. Like, this was all here.
All the podcast shit?
Yeah.
You just put your stickers on there?
Even those, your festive lights on your thing?
What is? Does it make you sad to know? Would you guys like to use this studio for 3 months while I'm in Australia?
No. We need the bar.
I want to rent it out. We need the bar. You can put a bar in over here. You need the bar. You set up a bar every time in a living room.
No, it's there all the time.
That's crazy. You're an alcoholic.
That's crazy.
You think I push that thing out in the living room every fucking day?
Your relationship is in trouble.
It's called coping.
Oh, shit.
That's good for. That's Whoa. Good for.
There we go. He's just letting everyone.
You didn't even hit
this.
Your bong. That just happened. You okay?
Is that in your body all the time? Jesus fucking Christ! You sound like Kool-Aid.
Right into the lighter too. He coughed right into the lighter. Cool,
guys.
Let it out.
This has been like when I invited you over here.
Uh-huh.
And I don't want to ruin my makeup.
But?
I put a lot of this eyeliner is expensive.
That's stupid. What do you think of fake lashes?
Don't say my eyeliner is stupid. I'm on my period.
What do you think of fake eyelashes?
I think they're hot.
Really?
Only if they're like over 2 inches.
Right. Like, it looks like they could fly away with them.
I like them to touch.
What do you think when they're on when they're on the lights of a car?
With
that's how I know when my Lyft is here.
When Waldorf comes to pick you up?
No. With his eyelashes.
By the way, why does everybody who drives Uber and Lyft, like, think about every friend you have who drives Uber and Lyft. Do you drive Uber or Lyft?
No.
Because this wasn't going in a good way. Every person I know who drives Uber and Lyft, like, I wouldn't let them drive me to the store, like, as a friend. Like, and that's what they do for a lip. Like, would you get in a car with Waldeck and let him drive you?
No.
To anywhere? Like, I dare you to turn your GPS off and get in a car with him. I dare you. That should be fear factor. Like, Rogan should come back to make show.
You gotta do 10 miles.
Yeah, what do I have to do? I gotta suck platypus semen through a crazy straw on an I-beam 20 feet in the air? No. You're getting this guy's trunk.
I used to do that in high school. When I was
put girls in your trunk?
Not girls. I don't know why you thought girls all of a sudden.
You know why.
I'm not one of those comics. No,
George thinks all black dudes are Suge Knight.
It's not even a black dude on the picture.
It's
Melton looking like Suge Knight.
Oh, do I want to test Collins? Yeah, let's try some Collins.
Yeah.
This can't get worse. We're going to start again.
I love how he reminisces. Oh, there we go.
I'm sorry.
That's not even the. It's this way for. What's that? Let's put an end to this.
That's an H.
I don't know how things work. 323-825-4990. Oh, God, that's online. And Nobody Likes Onions, all one word, on Skype if you... I just got a message here.
Yeah.
This is actually pretty interesting. I don't want to turn this down. I might want to return this call. Patrick, I think you could be a good fit for a writing opportunity. Offer is good until 3 o'clock. So
3 a.m.
Yeah, so I actually gotta go. Alex, are you coming over here? Because that's weird. And also, do bring food. What do you want? You want a chicken
Wendy's.
Sandwich?
Yeah, Popeye's is open.
And
I need something for this.
Any burrito slash. Actually, I'll take
go to a place with a chicken that sells the chicken sandwich. And
I'd like
burrito.
To take everybody out to Roberto's after the show.
Well, Alex is here in a heartbeat. Then
yeah. Oh, anything you want to order at Roberto's on me, Alex. Who's you hear that? Anything but fries. I refuse to support anybody ordering fries.
From Roberto's?
What do you have against fries?
At a Mexican spot?
If you go to Roberto's and get fries, you're not even my friend.
That's like getting tacos at Jack in the
you
Box.
You act like Roberto's is like this amazing Mexican restaurant.
Roberto's is the best
drunk
like
food.
Go to, but it's like better than like Taco Bell.
No shit.
But it's like,
that's why it's the best drunk food.
But why are you? No, I think it's like authentic, you know, super real stuff.
It's all right.
I know the guy who makes the tacos there.
Oh, that one guy
that makes all
in
the tacos?
75 fucking locations that are in Vegas.
Yeah, he makes them every fucking morning by hand.
Yeah.
And I'll appreciate you to wipe that smug sack of shit look face. Oh, that's a call.
Oh, damn, here we go.
I gotta change my ring back tone back to Nickelback.
That ring back tone's better than your intro.
I'd like to answer this. Hi, you're on the Onions.
Hey, is this the Everything's Going Okay in Vegas show, or you have one black guy and one white guy on
oh,
the
no.
show?
Oh, no. Hold on.
We're gonna,
I'm going to add Mikey from Edinburgh, Scotland on the call.
Wow, bro.
What is that?
Yeah, let's fire it up, guys.
Yeah. Hey, Scotland, go to Ireland.
What's up, Mikey?
Say what's up to my brother.
It's far too fucking early to talk about food. Put it that way.
It's far too far. Now, Mikey, you work for...
I do, indeed.
You're familiar with them, I assume.
Oh, that's why he hates doers.
Who knows more about whiskey, Tyler or Mikey?
Mikey.
100%.
Mikey's in Scotland and works for... I'm out.
A certified whiskey ambassador for Scotland. It's pretty much me.
For the whole country?
Yeah, but now, be honest. Yeah. What is Scotland know about whiskey? Fucking pussies. Do you ever see Jameson. Braveheart? Mel Gibson hates Jews.
Really?
It was like three thoughts in one sentence.
This is a real thing that happened.
They have a whole whiskey thing you can do at the castle. I think they know a little bit about it.
They can take our women, but they'll never take our... referendum. I don't know. You guys are fucked up politically.
Yeah. Really went off the rails.
No.
Impeach Trump. I got him back.
Yeah. The EU's collapsing.
I've been trying to hit this bog for 17 minutes. Steve. This is Steve. Steve in California. He's one of the biggest cokehead/drivers.
No, I gave it all up.
You're a quitter?
For the Lord?
Yeah, I'm a quitter now for the
nookie. Oh, okay.
That's worse.
So you can take that cookie then.
You know where to shove it.
Yeah, it was actually probably because of my blood pressure and heart and stuff. I think it had more to do with that. I'm a fat guy.
Well, let's introduce you to the whiskey guy, the whiskey ambassador.
They've already met.
Yeah, do you know Captain Scotland, the rep for all of Scotland?
We do. We have met.
We're actually friends, yeah.
We're here? Yeah. You met here?
No, I'm in Scotland.
Oh, what the fuck were you doing in Scotland?
Where did you guys meet?
Drinking, in Scotland.
Doing blow?
Oh, okay.
I mean, what were you doing in Scotland, motherfucker?
I never said I was there.
He flew to Scotland just to do blow with some dude? All right. And then he blew that.
That's weird. That's weird that you flew to Scotland
with fucking some random.
We did do any blow that whole trip.
I love that you flew to Scotland for more expensive, shittier blow.
Yeah.
How's the cocaine in Scotland?
No, you got to go over there to get it really stomped on.
I was in New York and I was like, wow, this blows horrible. How much shittier could it get if I go across the pond?
Is the blow in Scotland have like a peaty taste to it? It's so easy to hear you guys when you talk at the same time.
Mikey,
I'm not going to keep talking in front of them.
What's happening?
Let's start an international incident. Is there somebody we can call about this rape?
Yeah, which, bye guys, we're gonna investigate
the rape.
You better
get that black guy to your studio before I start having real problems.
Wow, oh,
there we go.
Okay, well, now we
Jesus
now
saves.
What now we have a thread.
Someone needed a spice. have been boring as shit.
So because we've been boring,
your alien-handed friend yesterday was fun to watch. This guy, he's just normal. He's cool.
Yeah, he is behaving tonight. And I think what happened is last time George was on the show, he was so insane that I thought he had a personality.
Yeah, no, that's your fault. That's your fault.
And now that I've asked him to dial it back a little bit, we realize there's nothing beneath the veneer.
It was nothing but chastising me.
Scotland, what's your favorite scotch?
Alex said I'm staying at home drinking out of my 32-ounce NLO cup. Please post that on Instagram. We're going to need a shot.
Hey, Scotland, what's your favorite scotch?
Favorite scotch is not... It depends on if it's right an now. Islet or a species.
At 8 a.m.
Mikey, are you drunk?
I might. It's fucking 8 a.m.
You heard me.
I am.
That's a good point.
We've been drunk at 8 a.m. before. I know you're drunk. Why are you drunk? You have to work tomorrow. You drive for Red Bull.
Yeah, I don't such a hard... Yeah, you missed a lot.
This guy drives trucks for Red Bull. He delivers Red Bull to stores.
You drive around and hand out free Red Bulls? I love that guy.
No, you know the guy who delivers Red Bull to the stores?
And like the Suzuki?
The
Suzuki sidekick?
He's the Red Bull truck driver. But only orange. He'll only do orange.
I only do the orange ones, and I only do children's hospitals.
Oh, my God. That sounds like Kool-Aid's
it's
roommate.
It's a bad sentence to say you only do children's hospitals.
Yeah, that sounds like Kool-Aid's roommate. You just said it.
Well, that's my new text notification when you message me.
I want you to taste what you're tasting.
Well, yeah.
My favorite scotch is Lagavulin.
Ooh.
Leg of what?
That's Lagavulin. Too peaty. It's too peaty.
It's pretty peaty.
Yeah,
it is. That's
you
a smoky motherfucker
about
right there.
That's a fucking, that's a thick one. You got to chew it a little bit.
That's what Ron Swanson drinks.
No, oh, shit. I used to drink.
What about Glenfiddich? How's that? Is
shut
that also?
Mustache. Glenfiddich.
Wow.
I'm agreeing with you.
Why do you? Yeah, who are you mad at here?
Red Bull?
I like yelling at people with mustaches. What?
Black people with
what
mustaches.
Happened? Was everybody your, did your in dad this room, have a mustache?
Everyone in this room has a mustache, and so do you.
Did your dad have a mustache?
Son of a bitch.
Did your mom have a mustache?
Yeah,
what
did.
Happened?
Yeah, she did. She sure fucked her asshole.
Dude, I didn't make her grow that. You're
Alex
sitting in a room by yourself right now, aren't you?
No, he lives with his dad. That was not a joke. Alex Ansel said, Tom Green owes me a Red Bull orange.
Tom Green didn't owe you
can
shit.
You block
what
him?
Does that mean?
Can you block him?
Can you? You know what I mean?
Can you block him? Hey, good.
Yeah, I'll block him like he blocks the sun.
That's forever.
Anyway, no, this has been great. Why are you being racist, Steve? You're a nice guy.
I'm just joking around, dude.
But you are in the Proud Boys. Do you guys know the Proud Boys?
No.
Is that a gay club?
Pretty much.
Some incel
are you still
shit?
Involved with those guys?
What are the Proud Boys?
Oh, God, don't start.
What are Proud Boys?
You brought it up. He didn't say it. You said it.
They're like the guys who like go fight the fucking Antifa at like UC Berkeley when Jordan Peterson wants to talk. You know what I mean? Like it's all.
You just go beat up.
They have barbecues and shoot people.
God.
You go beat up like 20 somethings, like young 20 year olds.
This last year happened down in Vegas, and it happened at someone's mom's house, and it was a. Turned out it was a sex dungeon.
Hey, just real quick, and everybody's house is someone's mom's house.
Did you pay to get into said dungeon?
No. But I was yelled at for taking a piss outside of it, and we weren't allowed to drink beer or do a blow in the basement of it. I mean, I don't know if any of that's true or not. I think I said
the two different accents on these two different callers are blowing my mind.
It's too
the sound quality is
much
that,
of a disparity.
Is that guy on a flip phone? What the fuck?
Are you driving with the window down?
Who's got that sound quality?
You.
That's why we called in the first.
The guy, Mikey has an iPhone. It's dead clear.
I have bad sound. Oh, it's probably because the FBI is monitoring my shit.
No, you have a headset like a fucking tool. You know what? You dress like a gamer and you use the phone like one.
You wearing a headset? Were you playing Halo? Check the right flank.
It's plugged
you faggot.
Into my phone.
It's plugged into your phone? Do you have your phone on your belt loop?
Yeah, just to hold your phone. I know you'd have to burn 16 calories.
Is this better? Is it better now?
Way better.
Way better. Okay. What's your favorite thing to drink?
Okay. Oh, I probably should have been holding it by the propane tank. That's
besides liberal tears. Am I right?
Get it together, Hank Hill.
Oh, shit.
What's your favorite thing to drink?
Oh, fuck.
This guy's a
the only thing that can make this better is a little royalty-free music. No, I'm just kidding.
Hang up?
No.
Why does it sound like the movie Signs?
I think he's out of breath.
From
Steve, why does it sound like you're trying to close your rings?
Are you rubbing the phone against your crotch?
What are you doing?
Are you tracking a woman right now?
Are you churning butter?
No, but I cannot explain what's happening with the extra noises that happens when I got headphone calls.
It's too incriminating.
Well, put your headphones back on. We'd rather talk to Mikey anyway. Mikey?
It's been happening for a long time when I talk to people.
No, listen, shut up for a minute.
Do me a favor, shut your mouth.
Mikey, do you guys have any questions about Scotland for a genuine Scotsman? Anything about whiskey?
How far away are you from Belfast?
An expert man?
About 240 miles.
As the crow flies?
As a crow goes through a labyrinth.
As the labyrinth flies. Hey, you should drive over and you should take some whiskey to my brother. He just had a baby.
That's not going to happen.
So you should
He's
do that.
In Belfast. He has whiskey.
Well, it'd mean a lot more.
Tell your brother to get his shit together.
Mustache off his face.
Jesus Christ.
What did I do?
Why are you so aggressive?
I've been nice to you.
Yeah, he's on your side.
I thought he hung up.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Never mind. We're good. I'm going to not smack it off then.
Thanks for taking it back.
Did his dad come downstairs to the basement? I don't get what happened. What was that turnaround?
Well, you're a real snake
charmer. I'm just getting attacked over here.
No, you're doing great.
I'm asking questions.
You're too hard on yourself, buddy. I think you're doing
great. I'm asking the hard questions.
You keep it up. You're doing great.
So how often do you guys get laid?
I'm going to fucking punch his mustache straight off.
This is a true story. I've actually... Here's what's nuts. You flew to Tulsa, and I watched you hit on a girl by telling her... He hit on a woman?
Dude, I'm so excited.
Like,
right now.
A guy asks...
No, what?
Did you fly to Tulsa?
You better set this up. You better set the
Who
story
says
up.
Who says shut this
I'm
up?
Set it up.
Set this up.
It's still so shitty.
Quit interrupting.
But I am headlining.
This shitty flip phone.
I am headlining. Six shows.
Just mute your Nokia for a second. Let us get the
loony bin.
Yeah. Your call is very important to us. Stay on the line. Yeah, the Looney Bin in Tulsa. I'm headlining like 7 shows. I fly out there. This nut flies there. Now I know him. We've hung out a lot. He's crazy as fuck, but he's funny as fuck. And I know it'll be a hoot. And it was. So we got a. I'm headlining the shows. The guy who brought me on stage the first time
Hold on.
Who was headlining
the
show?
No, yeah. Where were you on the lineup?
I was hosting and headlining, actually.
Oh.
I won't European let anybody style. Else introduce me. They fucking
right,
up.
Yeah.
But as headliner with your best friend in comedy managing the club, like one of these guys who burned out of comedy, Roy Johnson, real piece of shit.
You guys are still close?
We're still close. He runs the comedy club. So now it's like game on, you know what I mean? We're having a fun weekend. I have carte blanche. If you want nachos, I got it. If you want hot dogs, there's a wing night, I believe. I know a guy. And we throw down. So he flies out. We saw staff members from this comedy club.
It was honestly a rager until
7 a.m. two nights.
Shit nobody else
for two nights. Like for real. He hit on a woman who was probably 48. I call her Cruella Divorce.
Yeah, she was way definitely into her second divorce.
He's hitting on her by saying, and this is 100% true.
I'm fucking pins and needles right now.
You better tell this part right, because if you don't, I'll fucking tell it true.
Like a kid in high school picks a fight with somebody that they know they can beat, like meet me in the parking lot.
He's just real confident about fucking her?
Yeah, but he says, meet me in the parking lot. He's like, you come out to the parking lot, I'll eat that pussy.
Did she go?
I will lick that pussy. I'll eat that pussy. And then she would just say, like, whatever. The conversation would evolve into something else, and she'd just be like,
she just ignored it.
No,
because she's
like, hey, come to the parking lot. I'm gonna eat that pussy. And she was like, knows so what's your what's your favorite chicken sandwich?
She's a friend of a friend. So like, I knew she knew that if I brought somebody there, they weren't a fucking total nightmare. He's just a fucking idiot,
and he's just battling.
This
that
is a guy.
Safety
I
curtain.
Have a bit about him. We sat down. You know the diner in the Strat? Right. The diner in the Strat used to be the Ruby's or whatever, but now it's something else. We sat down there. A waiter came over and said,
like a Cadillac.
No, you talk.
Did he just say Cadillac?
I'll get my own podcast.
It started out as a Cadillac, and it moved into a Honda Civic, and then it moved into like an older Honda Civic, and then it moved into one of those knee.
What do you guys did a drive through on fucking Greece where you just go from car to car trying to fuck?
Yeah, no, that was the whole bit in my mind. It just kept.
I never heard any of that.
Smaller
several times he said, meet me in the parking lot, I'll lick that pussy. That's all I heard.
He just stayed with that.
Repeated it over and over and over. There was no. He's trying to make it like, no, it was actually a very nuanced bit. Like, no. There was no.
Did you eat a pussy?
No.
No.
It didn't work? Okay. Never mind. I won't try it.
I ended up pissing three different places in that fucking apartment before I flew out.
What's funny is two nights later, I was staying at Jeff's house, and she did so much cocaine and drank so much, she took all her clothes off and ran around.
Same girl?
Yeah. This girl. Jeff. Wanted to-
so you just didn't give her enough cocaine, dude?
Does Jeff own the comedy
yeah,
club?
Yeah, dude. Maybe you didn't put in enough for that coke.
How much was it, Coke?
Is Scotland still on the line?
I thought told her I'd eat her fucking pussy on a tricycle.
Okay, guys, we gotta get started.
I'm gonna be honest. Now hearing
the podcast.
Now hearing you say it in your sultry voice, I don't know how she passed you up.
Yeah. I don't know, man. I thought so too, dude. I thought I was like,
especially somebody who goes by Steve Taters.
What do you have? A motor swapped fucking JDM fucking Honda Civic in the parking lot? Oh, you pissed in that shit too.
So you told her it didn't matter what car she drove?
No, I just kept dropping the vehicle down to a lower and lower grade vehicle to kind of insult her. I guess it's kind of rude to do.
Hey,
it's a learning podcast.
I find the more you insult her, the more she gives it up.
I feel like you should give a little history of your problems you've had with substance abuse to put this whole thing in perspective.
I think we all kind of have it down.
Yeah, I think we all have an idea.
He's lost a job because he thought cocaine was more important.
First played out the next day, so I was like, "Fuck it, let's just burn it down," and that's what happened, man. It was just kind of funny. It's a funny situation I ended up in.
You fucking
we're in an apartment with a dog. Whole place smelled like piss. That's fine.
That goddamn
dog. Back there. And I was like, all right, let's make something of this bullshit.
Well, what's the worst thing you've ever done in your life, Steve?
Pins and needles.
Pretty much that.
No. I want to know your deepest, darkest secret that you never told anybody.
Come on, where's the body?
This isn't even recording now.
What?
Okay.
Yeah, we already left.
It's just us.
I'm running out of hard drive space, and frankly, this isn't worth it. What did you say? Where's the body?
Is Scotland still on the line?
Mikey?
Oh, yeah, he's still here. He's sitting waiting.
It's 8 in the morning, and this is what you're doing with your morning?
At this point, because it's
a
good mind.
We're talking to Scotland now.
I wanted to chime in about
What are you having for breakfast?
This is far more fascinating, really.
Yeah, Mikey?
What are you having for breakfast, Mikey?
Oh, look who's awake now.
Nothing. I'm always awake, bitch.
That's not true.
I'm not. Spoken like a what's real a, old man.
Mikey, what's a common Scotland breakfast?
Haggis.
No, I don't actually eat breakfast. I wait 2 or 3 hours because eating something in the morning makes me feel ill.
Fitness there nut.
You go. Okay, he didn't ask what you eat for breakfast. He said, "What's a typical?" All right, you talk again.
What's a common?
I'm sorry,
what's a common Scotland
bangers
breakfast?
Bangers and mash. Bangers and mash.
That's for. Are you just naming out shit? You're just calling stuff out.
Fish and chips, baby. On the newspaper?
It's called racist. Get it all out of your fucking
system. Get it all out of your system.
I apologize for George White, everybody.
And I want to say this. Just real quick to everybody watching. Both people who will watch this in the future and people watching live. And Tyler knows this, what I mean by this statement. I'm not sure you're even a person, but here we go.
That is unbelievably racist.
It has nothing to do with race and more to do with... First of all, I fucking hate white people, you piece of shit.
What is happening?
It doesn't mean you don't hate other people.
Arigato.
I hate all people.
The point is, I am used to doing a show that rambles and meanders and goes on tangents. I like that. It's fun. Let's play with it, you know what I mean? We all got in this business to not have four walls around us and rules. And people telling us what to do.
I like listening. And Tyler and I looking at people.
Oh my god, he came
eyes.
In last time. We came up with peanut butter bourbon. Oh, we riffed. It was hilarious. You're here now.
I'm like your audience.
This
member.
Is gone. This is so far off the wall. And this is coming from a guy who watched three naked men fuck each other under a shirt last night.
You're.
I mean, one of them's got to pay rent somehow.
If you want to join the overdose and see a video of Krim Waldorf teach you how to jerk off with a shirt. That's lube to him.
Does he fabric. Do that in an Uber while he's waiting for people to get in?
Yep. I didn't want to spoiler alert it, but you get it. And you've probably been in an Uber, so wipe the cum off your face.
Sorry.
Did you just pour Dewars?
Yeah.
Now, what do you want to talk
We're
about?
We're out of Coke, and I don't want to drink Jim Beam straight. I'd rather drink Dewar straight.
I'm sure he has Coke in the fridge.
I don't know. I think we're checking phone quality. How are we doing on that?
Your phone still you up? Think I would even have good. Such a sugary thing in my non-carb household, you would get fucked.
Up?
Or just it sounds good
yeah, I'm off carbs. I go get the chicken sandwiches at Popeye's now. I tell you, throw the bun away. I throw it right back at him. Say, hold on a minute, you old bitch.
Why don't you give it to someone
you
who
needs
it?
You got a picture up on the wall of don't let this guy back in because he keeps throwing buns at us?
Nope. I go to the drive-thru. They don't know the voice. I'm a Mexican woman when I drive through.
Let's hear it.
Ah, pequeño sandwich, por favor.
Damn.
Nailed it.
Do they have Mexicans in Scotland?
I do a lot of comedy. What?
Do they have Mexicans in Scotland?
Mikey.
They have Mexicans everywhere.
I don't know. We'll find out from the source.
It has not,
Ambassador.
Not anybody's allowed on
he
an airplane.
He said they do not.
Experienced.
No, they're allowed. Anybody's allowed on a plane.
We're not saying they're not allowed. People can be allowed places. I mean, they're going to
be there. You think right
now
in all of Scotland there's not one Mexican?
Shut I never up, said
mustache.
That.
They don't have them in Scotland.
Well, he's been there. He's
very
been
aggressive
there.
With Tyler.
The Coke ambassador.
Why am I getting hated?
Why are you beating up Tyler so much?
Because he's carrying the
you
show.
Look like you're a tiny man because the bottles look so big
it's
in your
camera
perspective.
It's a lot easier to hate the white guy than the black guy. Is that rude?
Hey, Mikey.
Of course.
Yes.
Do they have Mexicans in Scotland?
They do.
How many?
Several.
Can we keep
three
Mike?
Of them.
Can we keep Mikey on and hang up on the other guy?
I feel like they balance each other out really nicely. Actually, yeah. You're a mixologist. You should know this. Every bit of sweet needs a little bit.
One
of
them's
that.
A bit too abrasive.
A little bitter. No, too bitter Mike's for you.
One of them's a little
I'm
too peaty.
I bring my own bitters.
I can understand 10% of what comes through my
I'm
headphones right now.
I'm the aggressive and the more moderate.
I'll turn them up.
See, I'm like Scotland. You're like the L.A. rapist.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I'm like a rape. What'd you just say?
I think he called me
the first
a
time I've ever been convicted.
I'm subdued and
he
subtle.
He pointed at me.
I'm oh. subdued and subtle like the Petey Scottman. And then Tyler's abrasive and rapey like
the Petey Scottman.
The Tulsa rapist.
The Tulsa rapist.
Your buddy. He flew up to Tulsa.
Oh, my God. First of all, there's an actual very famous rapist in Tulsa called the Tulsa Rapist. And I'll be damned if he's going to take the title I've worked on.
I'm going to be honest. That's a lazy-ass name.
Tulsa. Especially if you live in Shreveport.
Where is Shreveport? Isn't that in Arkansas?
No.
Oh.
It's fucking Louisiana.
Oh. Hey, Scotland, have you been paying attention to Scotland. Our politics at all lately?
The whole reason I actually phoned in was to phone about your politics and the fact that Trump got impeached last night and the fact that it relates to
Yeah, but you're going to trust this guy? He's a part of the UK. You're more fucked up than we are. What do you know? You just had another fucking vote that you fucked up.
Yeah, and you fucked up. And the whole fucking thing's fucked up. And that's my fucking 2 cents on the whole thing.
Everything's fucked up.
We didn't fuck up again because we haven't re-elected Trump yet. We will.
Yeah, we will.
Haven't done it we yet.
Will. Oh, my God.
That's the thing. You will. That's the fuck
the problem.
That's so awesome.
Why is that the
Here's the thing. You've had like 17 things happen since Brexit the wrong direction. I'm confident one day we will turn around. Or and all hail Trump, you know? He's a good guy. Well. Give him a chance.
I think that I texted you last night.
Why do people not like Trump?
Can we all agree that socialism might not be the best thing for our people?
Well, that's racist.
Our people being... What is racist?
What do you mean, your people?
What do you mean?
Yeah, our people being America, being fucking Scotland, being anybody.
Way to backpedal and bring everyone into it.
You said anybody?
Okay, wait a minute, bitch.
You're talking about China?
Identity politics. Well, I'm moving it up.
You talking about China?
So our people
socialism works.
I was talking to Scotland. I was talking to Scotland, goddammit.
I knew I fucking had a problem with you for a reason.
You cocaine whore?
Are you not a fucking American?
Goddamn right I am.
Cunt. Excellent.
All right.
This Facebook thread came to life real quick.
Also not a racist.
Oh, yeah. Block me for sure, dude.
Is Mikey saying he's not racist?
Can we have a conversation about shit, or is it going to be too much for you?
Wow.
Look at Melton replying.
Did you put your headset back on?
Who?
Still on, yeah. Like,
we can see them? Are you looking at them?
Can you see them?
Is there video? Oh, there's just audio? Oh, okay. Why are you talking about headset? Who's putting headset?
Oh, he just sounds like shit.
Oh, I see.
Don't worry about it. I got the show, bro. If there was something available, I'd make it available to you.
Where's the Wendy's?
I would fly out to Vegas and argue with these assholes face to face, but it's not going to solve anything.
Wow.
Because they're going to trip about our people. Hey,
Curran, let me shut this down. Curran.
The West.
Mexicans.
The West in general, okay?
Curran. The West in general. I'm gonna shut this down real fucking quick. You're a drunk driver. You drive for a living, and not even Uber. No one can stand to be in the car with you except parcels. Do you understand? Like, you drive for a living. You're uneducated. You're a drug addict. You got fired from a job for drugs. You live with your fucking dad and your other relatives. You're a complete turd of a person. You've failed at all of it. So when you come around here hot stepping it, talking to friends of mine who have done things, you know what I mean, like driven to Phoenix or own a pig, you better get your shit in line.
Hallelujah.
You know what
you
I mean?
A fucking thing to
Merry Christmas, dude.
Hashtag Brexit, bro. We just burned your ass. Merry Brexit.
Our people. It's like, do you not understand how socialism is not good for America?
I think that was a pretty sick burn rant that I went on.
Socialism is great for America. Yeah. Otherwise, we have 3-year-old kids
I'm
working
kidding.
In coal mines.
Let me tell you something. Steve is
this
a professional.
Go off the rails.
No.
A professional troll?
Steve is a professional troll.
Yeah,
He's just fucking...
I know,
like, once he finds something... He'll just become that thing.
But he doesn't know that he doesn't know that I Miyagi'd his ass. I'm trolling him.
Oh, you've been re-trolled.
Yeah, Miyagi me, dog. Let me get that Miyagi. What you got? So socialism's good for America. Show me how.
Yeah, otherwise we'd have 8-year-old kids working in coal mines. I mean, is that what you want? Do you want 8-year-old kids working in coal mines? Labor laws exist because of socialism. So socialism's great. Am I right, Mikey? Chime in.
No, socialism's a horrible fucking idea.
Doesn't exist.
It's the shittiest fucking idea ever.
Can you let Scotland talk?
Capitalism works pretty good.
Round two.
Socialism works for China. China's the greatest exporter in the world. So there you go. Oh, you're going to bring up Venezuela? Oh, no. Here we go.
Another what happened to their economy? And that's where we get most of our fuel anyway. Fuck the Arabs.
Who's got the most socialist society that's most successful?
China. So.
Pretty good. Pretty good point.
China. China.
Mm-hmm.
Look at your room.
Oh, yeah, things are going great over there.
Yeah, look at your room. Look at all the shit made from China.
Yeah, look at Hong Kong. Everything's going good.
Well, Hong Kong's a spoiled little brat. Hong Kong, you're Hong Kong. That's it.
Burn.
You're right. You're right.
You're loud.
See how I said we should have hung up on him?
You're loud and annoying like Hong Kong.
This is the best high school debate I've ever been to.
Contention
more
one.
Annoying than Hong Kong.
Okay, we're going to put you on a timeout is what we're going to do. We're going to put you on a little timeout, Steve. Why don't you, we're going to
masturbate real quick.
Why don't you hang up, call back in 7 minutes when you thought about what you've done and you think you can speak to a colored person correctly.
Colored? Jesus Christ. We are in the 1920s.
No. Mikey is a ginger.
No, guys.
Mikey's a ginger. That's all I was saying.
Which one's Mikey?
The Scottish guy.
Oh, is it bad that
I wasn't
assumed?
Saying anything about anybody
Wait,
else.
What's the other guy's name? Steve?
Steve. He's dead. Okay. Oh, if you want to blow your mind, we'll get somebody from New Zealand to call in.
Crikey.
And add them to the Scottish.
Crikey.
You guys would be
okay, Steve. 7 minutes, Steve. Good. Steve, 7 minutes. Thank you. Okay, we got rid of him.
Jesus fuck.
Okay, well you don't need to be racist.
What?
Okay, well that's fucked. Don't be racist and weird.
We got a bootlicker and a bootlegger.
It's just annoying.
Yeah. I agree.
Welcome. What else do you guys want to talk about? Because
we never got down to Scottish breakfasts.
You're right. That has been swept under the rug.
I'm a breakfast person.
They're idiots. It's all beans. It's all beans and it's all toast. They're insane over there.
And
it's black pudding. Black fucking blood pudding.
That's breakfast.
That sounds delicious. I've lived in Edinburgh, Scotland 5 months of my life.
And it's fucking beautiful.
All they think is good for breakfast are flavorless sausages. Their sausages are completely derived of flavor.
In Scotland, do you feel like Lord of the Rings is like appropriating your culture?
In Scotland,
that's New Zealand. Next question.
Well, it's all green, is all what I'm saying.
Next question.
I feel good.
Which one of the hobbits is from Scotland? I feel like the
next question is
New Zealand. I mean, you are short.
He a wee man?
No, it's shit. Honestly, if you never tried black or blood pudding, as it's called, you haven't lived, honestly, really.
I mean, the name is so enticing.
Yeah.
What is it made of?
So it's haggis. I mean, as soon as you taste it, it's honestly...
Let me tell you what you have to worry about. Haggis? Nothing to worry about at all. It tastes like...
It's beautiful.
Shut up, stupid. Food can't be beautiful. Nothing tastes lovely.
Seasonings.
No, beautiful is how they describe flavor. Lovely is a taste. They're idiots.
Okay. What would you describe it? Salt.
Good.
So you mean an actual flavor?
Salt.
Great.
Yeah, no, they don't have a descriptor for food. Like, instead of saying something tastes good, they'll say it tastes
umami?
Nice or lovely.
Is
or
haggis
beautiful.
Umami?
Haggis? Shut up, stupid.
Mushroom-ish.
Just because you're both wearing the same hat, he is an icon, of an avatar, and it's wearing the same hat as you have
MAGA?
On.
Oh, my hat. Oh, tweed hats. Hell
you
yeah.
You have a MAGA hat?
I don't know if he had something in common with Steve.
Let's get Steve back on.
Nah. Make haggis great again?
Haggis is like stuffing from Thanksgiving, but super bland. Super bland. Like, so bland. It doesn't even taste as bad as it fucking sounds.
Is obesity
but
a problem?
All their sausages, all their kinds of things like that are flavorless.
In Scotland, is obesity a problem?
Oh, now.
Compared to the UK, yes.
Compared
in
to
comparison
the
with the whole the world, no. Oh,
okay. Compared with the US, no.
Yeah, because they have bland
food.
Yeah,
that's our thing.
Yeah,
that's totally
because we salt everything.
People think
we
people
salt the
think
rims
that
the of tequila
icebergs
shots.
Are melting and that the water's encroaching on the continent. No, we're getting fatter and we're pushing it underwater.
Yeah. We're sinking the country.
There's too much weight on this raft.
Is it like
Jack has to get off? Save yourself,
on
Rose.
This door,
Mikey. Is it like? Do you guys fight as much as America tells us you guys do? Like, when was the last time you got into a fist fight?
When's the last time you nutted someone?
Compared to what?
Mikey just used to run pubs, so he got in
fights.
Oh, yeah. Like, last week, did you punch somebody in their mouth?
When the doors? I got into a fist fight.
They don't punch, they nut someone.
4 years ago.
It's been four. Okay, so obviously that's debunked.
Because the ambassador doesn't.
No,
fight?
No, they do get.
He's a booze ambassador,
no.
So it's kind of.
But Mikey,
you drink a lot.
Hold on. But Mikey, they fight Patrick, a lot more.
Patrick explain this.
They
to his
just
bed.
Because he hasn't been involved. They fight a lot more. Every night we're out in Scotland in August, we see a fight every night.
What are they fighting about?
Just that particular
football
team?
Months? Yeah, fuck
well,
your
that's
football
when
team.
I'm there.
Oh,
but like they're violent.
East and West and basic
part
country,
of it.
Cultural differences.
Yeah, part of it is that 18-year-olds can drink, and people who are 18 don't think about consequences in their future.
Especially with
too young to be able to get shit faced.
I don't like sober 18-year-olds.
Like, imagine getting shit faced at 18. You're not really thinking about your future or jobs or like or being arrested or like what that means.
Especially with
so
your
like you're just
system?
A kid. You're a kid. And you're getting fucked up.
Like our healthcare system sucks, so we don't get in fights. But out there, everything's free. So yeah,
you guys got free healthcare.
You know, yeah.
Oh yeah, I broke my ribs in Scotland and got them X-rayed and CAT scan.
You got new ones for free?
Yeah, they 3D printed them while I waited. Fucking great. Scan my passport. Said, oh, extra large. We got them.
Extra salted.
Yep.
Fat motherfucker.
I had an old pair of Alex Hansel wasn't using.
Have you seen that? Oh, obviously, you haven't seen that dude sleep. It is disgusting.
Sleep?
Yeah.
Who you watch
who
him sleep?
Who's posting as the Nobody Likes Onions webpage? Somebody's posting as our page.
Is that you typing?
No, that's not me. That's what's creepy about it. I don't know who else would be an admin.
You've become too big.
No, maybe we've become self-aware. Maybe that's how this all ends.
Skynet, yeah. Started on the Nobody Likes Onions podcast.
Somehow, our organization is autonomously typing in our chat. Because that's crazy. Yeah, I haven't typed anything.
Yeah, you were typing earlier. I saw you.
No, that just came up. I didn't do that. And if you're doing it.
Reply to it.
I don't know who's. If you're doing it, stop. And if you're.
Stop. You've been commanded.
And if you're an AI, I always knew this day would come. So, you know.
Well, it's not me.
It's Mikey.
Let me off the hook.
Mikey, what's your favorite type of porn?
The peaty kind.
Oh, we got Steve wants back on. Should we give him another shot?
But before he comes back on, by the way, I love your porn stash.
Oh, Steve. Kills. Steve, sorry. We
Thank you, Scotland.
You. We really wanted to get Steve, but we missed him.
Shucks.
Mikey, can you get on video for us?
He probably had to hang up because he was doing coke.
Yeah.
No. It's definitely not for a job interview.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Everybody. What are you doing with your day, Mikey?
Jesus Christ.
Me, I'm off until January.
Oh yeah, you guys get like a whole month off.
Why don't
right?
you pick Alex Ansel
not
up and come on?
Busiest Fuck season.
You. As someone who's worked for the last 12 years over every Christmas Eve and Christmas Day and Christmas fucking Boxing Day and all this shit for the last 12 years. Fuck you. I'm taking this 12 days.
I'm not mad that you're off, man.
Why,
congratulations.
Who are you upset at? I'm glad they don't have guns.
I
won't
say to anyone who asked me
about your days off.
Yes,
that's
fuck
a
you.
Bit aggressive.
Yeah, fuck you,
very.
And do you think Scottish people should have guns like Americans?
No. I'm going to answer that. No.
Yeah. Did you hear the anger in his voice?
Do you think
over
Americans? Do you think Americans should have guns like Americans?
Pussies.
No. No.
No, there's no need for guns, but we love them like we love breasts.
I love a bit of violence in it.
That's
chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim cheroo. I pulled on me trigger. That's the end of you. Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim cheroo. A life taken's easy can be. I squeezed on me trigger and bye bye says me.
Did he hang up?
No, I don't know.
Your accent is shit because it sounds like Birmingham and.
Yeah, it's Cockney.
I thought he was going to go with the melody.
Cockney? It's doing Cockney Dick Van Dyke as fuck.
Yeah, you sound like Michael Caine.
Yeah. All right. Other day, mate Derek, other day, I popped down the pub, you know, just hanging out at the shops.
Right-o.
Mate comes up to me, he's like, oi, you taking a piss? I'm like, yeah, of course. You know what I mean? I'm just shining his shoes.
Gripping
having a go. Just having a go, shining his shoes, giving him what for. He comes around the corner. He says to me, tally ho on me winkle, what's it? I said,
and I went, what way are you? Hit my water. Fuck you. Fuck. Oh, I need you in the
room. I like this guy.
I like Mikey.
Call again, Steve. We'd love to have you. I'm sorry. It just keeps disconnecting.
We're all broken up about it.
No, I gotta get Rusty in here to fix stuff.
Oh God, really? Do we have to?
So I heard you're alright. I heard you're transitioning. I didn't know how to bring it up, but you know, if you're gonna rush me and make it weird, I heard you're becoming a woman.
So you're cis transgender male becoming a cisgendered female. Yeah, discuss.
That's you, Mikey?
Yeah, that's when did you decide to do this?
No, that's you. Yeah, I mean, discuss.
You want us to talk about how we feel about you doing it?
No,
are you drinking already,
are
Mikey?
Are you okay, bro?
No, I thought you were bringing someone else into.
You all right, dude?
You drinking your tea? Your bangers and mash? What's going on, Mikey?
Wow, sounds like a real problem. This could go anywhere.
Are we bringing someone else?
What just happened?
Do you hang up on Mikey?
Who are you calling?
Oh, you're calling Steve?
Find out somebody who knows about this.
Bit, dude. Why the fuck you gotta hang up on me 3 times? Because of mustache?
Look how mad. Look what you've done to this boy.
What did I do?
Tyler's like, I'm missing sleep for this. At least there's whiskey. Good stuff, not that Scottish shit.
I can't believe you fucking did that to me, dude.
Who are you mad at?
This man at libtards.
No.
I have a limited plan with cocks, and we don't get that many
megabytes.
I'm just kidding.
I don't have anybody's social media's names anyway, so it's a joke.
You backpedaled real quick again.
First of all, that's a weird threat. Like, yeah, I got your social media names. Like,
you guys are going hard as fuck at Mike, and I'm over here just in the corner. Like, that's fine.
No, what I'm
hard at my fucking friend.
No, I feel like that's what fine. You're into.
Sitting in the corner and watching us go hard.
Look. Lemonparty.org.
See how he didn't get it until you explained it to him?
Exactly.
That's
rudimentary. My dear Watson.
That was Mustache's joke you were laughing. I got to use nicknames. He doesn't know.
Thank you.
I'm trying to be
I'll
a
just stick with that. I don't need him to add me.
Like, I like fucking ketchup on eggs. And I'm like, no, fuck that guy.
What conversation are you on?
Yeah, you're in another planet.
You called him another podcast?
How many podcasts are you crashing, bro?
He puts ketchup on eggs, and I'm like, I'm not a fan of that.
You're in a weird mess.
I never said that.
Bro, we were talking about haggis before.
I'm a breakfast fan.
What's your ideal breakfast? Shut up, Steve. What's your ideal breakfast?
Fucking all of it at the same time. No, I'm a big biscuits and gravy person. I've recently... Shut the fuck up.
It's like if Rush Limbaugh had a bobblehead that was broken and wouldn't shut up.
Can you laugh? Not into the phone?
Sometimes I think your chin is just in perpetual motion.
Oh, does he have an Alex Ansel style chin?
Oh, no. Come on. Nobody has that jawline.
No one has that big of a body.
That's fucked up. Alex is still watching. That's fucked.
Is Mikey still
watching?
Yeah, Mikey's not on the phone.
I don't
anymore.
Know, man. You guys were fucking real hard on my boy Mikey, and I just felt like I had to step up.
We weren't. He was just saying fuck a lot. I don't know if that's just what Scott's
doing. The point, where's your go-to breakfast place? Because I like somewhere Denny's. Like Hash House or Go-Go.
It's all local.
Hash House is a little too over the top.
You know? Okay. Shut up. As a go-to standard, I like Black Bear.
Black Bear Diner?
I'm a Black Bear guy.
Black Bear Diner is the only one that's national that's a good breakfast place that's kind of all over.
Blueberry Hill?
It's not half.
I've never been.
It's good. On Flamingo?
There's a bunch of them, though. There's a few.
Oh, there are?
Yeah,
there's only one.
I like the shittier places. I like the no-name spots, you know? I like
just like Dad used to make.
You like asbestos?
Yeah, I like it where, like, you can see the cook, and he's got, like, Band-Aids on his hands because he cuts himself so much, you know?
You like salmonella.
I like the fucking gritty fucking breakfast spots.
Syphilis.
Okay, so you like something like... What do you order? Like, what are you ordering?
I like biscuits and gravy. I like eggs, chicken and waffles.
Waffles,
sausage gravy.
Do you put butter on your waffles?
The breakfast gravy.
Yeah.
Do you put butter on your waffles? Give us some nice umami.
I'm American. You fucking put butter on everything.
I don't put syrup on things. Just butter. I like my pancakes with a stick of butter. Who's here?
Butter and jelly.
Mikey.
Inhale.
Yes. Well,
okay. Damn. What changed about your setup? Okay. Stop talking so close to the phone.
I can't.
There we go.
There you go. Yeah, better.
Nailed
much
it.
Better.
Nailed it, Mikey. Welcome back.
Yeah, we loved having you.
See,
gone.
It's like I almost kind of not work in this.
He's drunk.
You are drunk. It's 8 a.m. and
it's
Scotland
his vacation.
And you're drunk.
You got a lot vacation. To do on your day off, Mikey?
Yeah, just drink.
Yeah.
Mikey, are you drunk? Fittage. Are you drunk right now?
No.
You lying.
Yeah, a little bit of Lagavulin.
Hey,
I hear.
Hey, is Jameson good?
It is good, but it's an Irish whiskey. Oh.
You're half Irish, you sack of shit.
Yeah.
You what about back. Pretty good, solid one.
What's your point?
I'm half Korean, so we're both happy.
You expect us to believe you're not drunk? I mean, we all vote drunk, right?
Yeah, I vote drunk.
Listen to him.
Well,
is it snowing out there?
Nope.
Does it snow in Scotland?
Sorry.
Does it snow there?
No, not really. Not there, bro.
Does a lot of rain?
Kinda. It's like a microclimate thing.
I saw a show where you guys deal with a lot of biker gangs. Is that true?
I saw a show where a monkey performed surgery on a kitten.
On the kitten. Did they give him haggis afterwards?
I have no idea what the fuck that is.
Haggis? You don't know what a monkey is?
Haggis is like a traditional dish in Scotland. Don't you mind? Wow.
I set myself up for that. Haggis, yes. Monkey.
You don't know what a monkey is?
A monkey show?
What do you guys say after this show? We go down to the all-you-can-eat strip club and I buy everybody around the mashed potatoes on me.
Let's go to Coronado Cafe in South Point. Get some $3.
He thinks you're serious.
Breakfast.
He was really excited about getting free
food. I want bangers and mash. Fuck.
I would. You get bangers and mash for $3.99.
Yeah.
And what are bangers and mash?
Bangers, those are sausage links, and mash is mashed potatoes.
No, I know what they are. They actually have that as a breakfast
sausage,
option.
Sage and onion.
Sausage, sage, but nobody likes onions. Boom. Done. That's it. That's a wrap. Hour and 27 minutes.
Yep, where's my air horn sound?
Here, you ready?
We'll add it in post.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Put it in. No, we'll actually have a lot of air horn sounds now. Oh, I just renamed the air horn sound Spacebar, and then it disappeared from the search, and now I'll never find it again. Because how do you search
for a
space?
Well, this whole show is fucked now.
No, I don't even have a hard drive.
Oh, shit.
Most of this is hooked up.
Steve doesn't have a hard drive. Are both of them still on the phone now?
Yeah, Steve's sulking.
Nobody's on the phone.
Yeah.
Are the both of them calling in?
Hold on, you can hear him too?
I just hear someone breathing heavily.
It's not. It's just background.
It's not me.
Hold on. So where?
So it must be the other
he
one.
He wants to go to South Point for $3.99 bangers and mash, which is a real. Is that a real breakfast item?
No, not there.
So no.
What is it? What is $3.99?
It gets you sausage, sage, and onions.
Sage?
Yeah.
At South Point.
No, no, no. In Scotland.
What are you talking about, South Point?
In then? Scotland.
Yeah, I'm asking about South Point.
Yeah, that's where the comedy show's at.
Yes, you said you wanted to go to a place for breakfast.
Can you start
South
drinking
Point.
Water, George? We Jesus can, Christ.
We can go to Blueberry Hill. We can go to Blueberry Hill
no,
if you want.
No, you said
he
I want
to.
Where do you want to go? P-Melt, where do you want to go?
Am I insane or is,
no,
is it
he's
clear
so,
what
like,
I'm asking?
A little bit.
I feel like he knocked his
you
head.
You brought up the name of a restaurant at South Point and said you wanted to go there, and I'm asking why.
We can if you want.
See how you didn't answer?
He's
just trying to piss you off.
Am I in a fucking vortex?
No.
Okay.
You're
brought
studio.
It up. You want to go. You brought it up.
I'm checking posts if I brought it up. I
we
don't, even
don't
know.
Have that.
You got instant replay. Let's do
no
it.
No one is.
Let's do. Burr, 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 burr.
I can't instant replay a time ago I'm not aware of. I'm asking you now what the name of the restaurant in South Point is.
I feel like it was like 4 minutes ago.
Okay. Can you just, go can back you just that cut far. Me out of this whole episode?
No.
You just had to be
us.
You and him.
How good do you think CGI has gotten?
I don't know. I saw Yoda as a cartoon.
By oh, the yeah. way, are you on board with this shit?
Baby Yoda is pretty dope.
Because Alex is jerking off to this.
Babe Mandalorian?
Yeah.
Or to us.
Are you into this?
I assume Alex is jerking off
you
to
have
both.
Disney Plus?
Yeah, of course I do.
Do you?
No. Oh, yeah, yeah, we have it. We got it free with Verizon for a year.
Get the fuck.
Do you have Verizon out?
Am
in
I
Scotland?
The only adult left on the planet?
Dude, that's it's not a $7 filter. A month. Just get it.
I love that you think it's the goddamn price, you sack of useless shit.
For what? Beauty and the Beast and Little Mermaid. And what else? What for Aladdin? Fuck off.
First of all, I hadn't thought about Little Mermaid being on there because yeah. I wanted to get down with that shit.
There's a cartoon, too.
I want them to do a live-action Ariel show where she's just not sure if she should go back to the sea.
Yeah, well, do it, then. Why not?
Scott, are you watching Mandalorian?
No.
No.
He just shit all over Disney Plus.
It's not available in my country. Fuck off.
We win.
Do you, no, we yeah. don't.
Do you have
you're an adult
Scotland?
Man in an adult relationship. You're a happy, in productive member of society with a job. Why are you so excited about Star Wars?
The Mandalorian's a good show.
Is it?
Yeah, Jon Favreau, dude. He's
what's
a fucking
beast. What's the premise
beast.
Of it? Give it to me.
It's like a, it's like Star Wars and a Western at the same time. It's fucking solid.
So it goes back to the old
explain
Star
it to
Wars
me.
Feel with the cantinas.
So it's between the original trilogy and the Disney trilogy, right? So everything just crumbled, right? The Empire's done, and it follows a Mandalorian, which is fucking Boba Fett, but it's not like Boba Fett's a Mandalorian. I'm just bringing you up to speed.
Well, what right? is a Mandalorian? That's like a religion?
No, it's a planet.
It's a robot.
It's not a robot.
It's a Roomba.
It's yeah, right? So
what
they just clean
Yoda?
And
what
no.
What race is Baby Yoda? Fuck off.
No, and that's that's what I think what's keeping
everyone.
You
thinking everyone, what I'm thinking? Greek.
I think that's what's keeping everybody interested is we're waiting to find out what Baby Yoda is. Because that's not even his fucking
it's a
name.
Fucking Greek.
Get him to yeah, the Baby Yoda.
Yoda is the thing that he's
spit it out.
So he's associated
English
with,
much?
Did you just have a stroke?
But no one's
he's
no
drunk.
One's instead, Lucas hasn't
thank
said
you.
What that race is.
You getting ready
fuck
to take
you.
9 a.m. naps?
Fuck off.
Jesus Christ, I've seen fucking Josh Blue deliver a punchline cleaner.
Wow.
That's what's known as a... I can't find my air horn after that. God damn it.
Comedian. I'm getting lambasted by comedians.
What was that word?
In the morning.
Lambasted.
Bamboozled? No.
Are you not a Star Wars fan, Scotland?
Nobody's a Star Wars fan. They're awful movies.
No, yeah, no, it's totally garbage. It's not making any money at all.
I dare. Yeah, nobody's.
I saw the next three. I thought they were shit.
I'm sorry. For a minute, I thought. Shut up.
I'll be honest. Hearing a Scottish person like ramble and bitch feels good. I don't know why.
Let me tell you
they just have the voice for that.
Let me tell you something.
It's like Scotch whiskey came to life.
They're just because they're making money isn't a fucking hallmark of whether it's good or not.
Yeah, I agree.
There's a lot of shit comics out there right now. Eliza Schlesinger has her fourth Netflix special. Are we supposed to think that's good?
I agree.
No, yeah, Star Wars.
Don't fire until you see the whites of their wines. If anything's ever made you feel like brushing your teeth with a shotgun,
it's The Mandalorian.
Are you going to cry?
No, I'm saying this. It's fucking garbage. It's
the Mandalorian's
good. Garbage, and now Disney bought it, and they're just churning out shit in this formulaic shit that works. Of course it sells. I'm not saying they don't know how to put a story together. Pixar movies and Disney movies are some of the best well-told stories ever. They're good at it. It's garbage. You need to get on this Grey's Anatomy shit. You know what I'm saying? Don't sleep.
I like Private Practice.
Don't sleep on Private Practice. Yeah. Great spinoff. But also that new shit is The Good Doctor. That shit is on fucking point. And also shout out to my fucking Rookie of the Year, New Amsterdam.
You know what?
Can I say this?
Rookie of the Year, go any solid further? Movie.
You
get to see Rookie of the Year if you get Disney Plus.
The point is this. You're all fucking...
You get to see heavyweights?
Filling up your own snow boots with jizz over Baby Yoda.
You know what?
And let me tell you something.
The memes are better than the
it
show.
Let me tell you how creepy it's getting. It fills all the cracks, and your feet are warmer than they've ever
been. Here's what's going to happen. If you're so fucking frothed over a younger version of an ancient character... Why don't we just take everything back to when it was cum?
Good.
Why don't we take everything back to when it was baby cum?
Dude, your whiskey looks like your bong water.
Don't worry about it. I drink both.
It's gross.
Why don't we just go back to when Pinocchio was a baby wooden sperm?
Because that
and give him his own show.
Hi, everybody. He came to life when he
I cannot tell a lie.
Is that Mickey Mouse?
That was George Washington.
Dead on.
Okay,
the point is, you've
Mikey,
all seen.
So, Mikey, Home Alone George Washington 2. Is our first president.
Home Alone 1 and 2 and 3 are on Disney Plus.
And the president is kind of like the prime
Darkwing
minister.
Darkwing Duck.
I need to know about
Tailspin.
Why is everybody so crazy over Baby Yoda? What's the point?
It's adorable.
What's the point?
It's adorable.
Mikey and I are bonding over U.S. history. So, George Washington was our first president. And presidents are very much like prime ministers, except they don't have to answer to royalty.
Who are you explaining to?
Do you think girls are like masturbating to Baby Yoda? Because that's a crime.
Don't mansplain to us.
Don't Scott-splain.
I love the fact this explains to me like I don't fucking know this.
I'm just making sure.
Dude, quit talking down to Scotland.
Let me ask you this as these MacBooks get more and more powerful.
No, seriously, go ahead, try and tell
what do you
me something.
Think what is this a crime if you can render realistic CGI of a child you know naked and then
stop. I don't know where that was going. I don't know if I want to know.
It's a hypothetical, so there's no danger in it.
There was something you were going.
Are you into free speech or not?
You have to tell me.
Are you American or not?
All right, tell it for Scotland.
It's not telling it. I'm asking. These are like real things. I watched a comedian one time in Scotland hold up a picture of drawn child porn and say, is this illegal?
Was it smaller stick figures? Jeez. How good of an artist were they?
That was actually the joke. He did it first with a realistic picture and then with stick pictures and said, is that any better? But it is an interesting question. What's the thing that's illegal? Is it the ethics of what's behind what's happening or the fact that there is a real person whose rights have been violated? Like if I can generate CGI of a legal picture of a child, I just have their face, I do a deep fake onto a fucking rendered CGI body of a child.
That would be porn.
Child porn.
But that's Edinburgh. That's
but, it,
could,
but it wouldn't be illegal
because
it's
fucking
it's
fancy.
It's, no, it's, a, still would be it's a rendering.
Still be, Okay, yeah, so if you jerk it off to like, so if fucking Rugrats does a porn.
Yeah.
You know,
you've seen Simpsons porn and Family Guy porn.
Right, that's why I went to Rugrats. Yeah.
So Rugrats is an American TV show. And it's
and they crawl around on a rug that's full of jizz.
So we all know Chucky and
all right. So Chucky is actually
Chucky
is actually a doll that gets possessed by a murderer. That's a different movie.
Well, I wasn't gonna bring it up, but you started it.
God damn it!
You're thinking about a different movie, Mikey. I'm sorry.
Do you not know Rugrats?
Chucky was a character.
Yeah, Chucky's the guy who had the overalls. He was the doll, and
Chucky was the
Child's Play.
Yeah, Child's Play.
Charles Lee Ray.
Yep.
Lee Ray, yeah.
Carnage.
Yeah.
When Venom goes to interview Charles Lee Ray in the prison.
Oh, my. Holy shit, you're more on.
Louis Dimbala, give me the power, I beg of you.
Is that Shazam?
Are you going to become? That's Child's Play.
Oh, shit.
That was the spell. That was the, like.
It was actually pretty dead on.
Oh, I know. I didn't have parents.
Oh, my God. That was amazing. All right, so.
So what are you guys doing? Spending Christmas with your families?
Yeah, going to Indiana.
Pieces of shit.
I got to drive to Washington.
That sounds awful. My parents are dead, so I usually just order Uber Eats. It's pretty dope.
Do you see that photo? There's a dude taking a shit in a stall with Uber Eats bag on the floor.
Yeah,
I'll never order that shit.
How do you know if he was the delivery driver or the receiver?
I don't give
no because it was the carrier bag.
Yeah,
it was
the
bag
carrier
to keep
bag.
The food warm.
So he got the food.
Oh,
took
as
a
long
shit.
As it was sealed, then.
You want fecal matter,
dude? I like that you think their cars are cleaner. We just talked about who drives Uber.
Yeah, Steve. Is Steve still here?
No, Steve got real racist and ran away.
Good riddance.
Oh, we have another Scottish person. Laura just joined.
Hey.
Really? Yeah. Oh, dear.
Do you know her?
You're going to be here.
Oh, yeah.
You guys live on the same street?
You guys work in the same company? Is she
These are fans that when I work in, I do Edinburgh, Scotland every year. They come out.
And then you do Fringe in Australia.
And Laura and her husband were just in Vegas like 2 2 weeks ago.
Oh, they didn't come see me? Oh, that's right, because I don't get booked. Fuck you,
They came out to two shows at the OYO, and you weren't on either of them.
Yeah. Fuck you, Alex. When are you coming down here?
By the way, I'll be at the OYO Thursday night. Come on out and see me if you're...
This Thursday? Tomorrow?
Today.
Today?
Yeah.
Like today.
Why are you smacking your lips like that? Why do you keep looking at your watch while you smack your lips?
Because he's getting messages, remember?
Is churches open?
I don't fucking know.
Is there a church's chicken here?
I live in a nice neighborhood.
I love a black guy. I'm cutting out just that clip of him going, is there a church's chicken here? Please tell me I got it. Yes, it's on him.
We got to get that shit, man.
We're hitting it.
Yeah. All right. So Church's Chicken is an American chicken franchise.
What do you think of churches?
Who are you explaining to?
So Mikey and our Edinburgh friends.
You think we're making our own Wikipedia?
Mikey, what's your fast food restaurants? Are they different from ours?
Bangers and Hash.
KFC is super popular.
Bangers and Hashtag a go-go.
Oh, you guys only got KFC?
Ugh.
Which I've never been to in my fucking life.
The Colonel's 30 spices.
They just started getting Taco Bells.
Oh, my God. That authentic
They got five
Mexican
guys.
Food.
They got Edinburgh has London. Like three five it's guys.
Been, it's not a thing.
Three guys?
You like Five Guys, though,
they
Mikey?
Three guys?
Yes, I do love Five Guys. Been there twice.
What do you think? This is my thought on Five Guys. What do you think their price point on potatoes is?
We're not supposed to bring that up.
The price, the actual price point at the point that they're selling their fries.
Because they fill the whole bag with fries. Do they do that over there?
Do they have peanuts over there?
Right. They do. They do have peanuts because they actually fry in peanut
oil. They do have peanuts over there.
I heard, they have peanuts over there. Thank God they have peanuts.
I don't care. Is the point.
I love looking at myself on that.
Thanks for being part of the conversation.
Yeah.
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 What was your point in the initial?
I just think they give so many fries away that I feel like they have to have like a really good fucking deal.
They give too much fries.
They have to, it's a lot.
So you think
it's a lot. So
there's
like,
kind of, there's a corporate, you know, wastage of money.
No, but it's their thing. Okay. They're doing
How
it.
How drunk are you, Mikey?
No, but he's got a point. They're doing it because it does what it's doing now. it makes people go like, oh my God, the thing for fries was full and then like double that was just dumped in the bag.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Have you been there? So you just do like why, now it's a thing you? People talk about.
Yeah.
It's brilliant. Yeah.
Like the Jesus verses on the bottom of the cups. I'm not supposed to say it,
but I get a cut.
I used to do a restaurant. I used to have a restaurant. And our thing was, we were a pizza place. And if you came in and ordered a large pizza, what I would do is just take a giant shit on every pie. And sometimes, like, I couldn't shit
like
that
South
much.
Like South Park.
So I'd have to, like... Did that happen in South Park?
The shit burgers? Simpsons did it before. The shit burgers? Probably Simpsons did it first.
Oh, my
probably.
God. Well, then there's no ideas left, you know? If I can't shit on a pizza and be called a genius, I don't want to be in this world.
I mean, goals.
Bye.
Well, God damn it.
What did, Mike,
another Scottish person just joined.
See, we're blowing up in Scotland.
Yeah. Hey, chime in. What borough do you live in? What village do you...
These are Glaswegians.
What Glasgow, do you hail
Glasgow.
From?
Glasgow.
Is there a native language in Scotland? Scottish?
Yeah. Oh.
Is it called,
English.
Yes. English?
Is it called Glen? Like, what Glen do you live in?
Nope.
They're cities.
Glen, isn't that a hill? Like a hillside?
Oh, my God.
What is a Glen? Is that like a gully?
Glen is a guy your dad golfs with.
Glen is a gully. He's not too far wrong from that.
Glen, so if they live Glen in a, Gully, Glen Ross. If,
whiskeys for closers.
If it is from east to west, then this will be great. I love
so
this.
A glen is east to west and a gully is north to south?
Depends God. On the city and depends on that's within the city as well.
I'm learning a lot. Right? I really appreciate being
moving
here.
My gully from side to side.
Glen Gully, Glen Ross. You fucker. Fuck off. That's what I'm going to start saying from now on. Dude, Mikey, that's so great.
Who is it, though?
Yeah, fuck off. Glen Gully,
Glen Ross.
Is it
Paul or Laura? Because this would be fun.
Paul and Laura are in the chat.
Oh, fuck me, yes. This would be great.
Fuck you, yes?
Bring them into the phone call. Hey.
Oh.
Call
if
us.
If you can understand me, then you will struggle to understand
oh,
me.
Oh, are they gibbos?
They are more...
Wow. You're not allowed to say that anymore since the riot.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. That's more politically...
Oh, that's...
Shouldn't say that.
You're telling me you're not on drugs.
There were riots?
Mikey, you holy sound shit. Like a fucking nightmare. You sound like a wreck.
It's an accent.
No, he's a
Glaswegian person.
You're slurring like a goddamn... okay, we need a Glaswegian person to call in. 323-825-4990. That's American.
Excuse me.
Plus one in front of that. And then nobody likes onions on Skype as well, you could do. And that
we is pay, that your phone number?
We pay for that.
Is that your phone number that we can
323-825. It's the show's number.
Oh.
We try.
That links up into
we
the
Skype. We don't want to set up like your dad's office.
Hey, remember when Steve was part of the show? Fuck that guy.
We used to only take faxes during the show. That's a real thing. In 2011, I set up a fax number and told people we'd be the only
get
podcast
the fuck
with a fax.
Out of here.
No, we were the first podcast, and as far as I know, the only podcast that took faxes and talked about them on the show.
Who? How many faxes did you get? A show?
A ton, because for people real? Like did them from their office and shit that has a fax machine. Like people still fax. It's crazy. How else would they have caught Kevin Spacey at the end of the usual
how
suspect?
Are you still this unsuccessful?
What are you talking about?
This nigga drips in success. What?
Let me tell you something.
Tell me.
Tyler S. Jolley.
Don't. That's my middle name.
Is it
Steven?
Really? Because I totally guessed a letter.
Yeah, no, you're way off.
Okay, it was L. Here we go. Was it L?
Tyler Lincoln Jolley.
What is it?
He's not going to say it. It's Perump.
The fact Tyler that you don't want to talk Jolley. About it makes me want to devote 2 hours to this.
Yeah, okay. It's my mom's maiden name.
Well,
actually.
I don't want to. Yeah, you don't want to give that out.
Yeah, nah.
That's a dumb way to name.
Really,
a
your middle name is your mom's maiden name.
Yeah.
That's what goofy. Were we about to square Jefferson. Off about? Because I forgot.
Glasgow.
How successful you are.
Oh yeah, I was really mad. I completely forgot.
Like, you really hold a grudge.
I gotta. Yeah. I'm a nightmare.
I was really mad.
Listen here, you piece of shit.
Oh, you had to get the cameras ready before you ranted.
Yeah, it's all a character.
Hey, real quick.
I cried.
Are you going to delete this video off the live thing after it's done? Because it'll stay in Facebook unless you delete it.
I call Mark Zuckerberg. Whatever he does is fine.
You just leave it up to him?
He's got him on speed dial.
I set the permissions to default.
Do you think people still have speed dial?
I do.
What are you talking about? On phones?
I guess everything's speed dial.
Yeah, you just ask Siri to call whatever.
Yeah.
Do you do that? Do you do that?
If I'm driving.
Do you drive? You're not that responsible.
I tell my car to tell my phone to call Siri.
Hey, Chevy, tell Siri to call Tyler.
But
Jolley.
You see my car. It's the yellow 97 Sunbird with the stripes.
Oh, it used to be a cab?
Yeah, it used to be a cab. But it used to be the cash cab. No. They decided it was too small for cameras.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They tried.
It's a coupe. So it was rough.
Laura's not calling.
No, she died earlier.
Rest in peace, Laura.
It was a chat room fire. I was going off. We'll edit all this because this is definitely not funny.
I'm having a fucking blast.
Mikey's
you
loving it.
Here's the thing about you.
I forgot I had them on. They're so comfortable.
You want to do this?
Easy.
Because right. Square. Oh.
Did he throw his headphones?
No, I just can't hear without these, actually. Okay.
I'm just going to yawn into my hand again.
It's wrapped around my bad foot.
A whole thing.
Yeah.
Your bad foot.
No, this will all be edited. And believe me, I'll come out of this tough.
Tomorrow he's recording himself going, you know what? And another thing. Fuck you, Tyler.
I dub it all. Very well.
Hey, there's a 50-minute podcast. Nothing.
Is that your podcast?
He burned us
all. No, this is all going to be cut.
Boxes.
Here we go. Do the thing again where you go like, how are you this unsuccessful?
Yeah. Do that again.
We'll put it in. Oh, I'm all just right. Over here. Hold on. I act like I'm about to do a bong because I'm a drug addict.
Yeah. Okay. You ready? How'd you get such pretty eyes?
But I'll just throw the audio in from earlier. Yeah. It doesn't matter what you said.
How are you this racist?
Go.
When did you become such a piece of shit?
How am I so unsuccessful?
Uh-huh.
Your pig goes to a public school.
Yeah. They don't have private schools for pigs yet. Yeah. We're working on
it. That's a good
point. Got to pass the legislation.
That's a good point. Also, you want them to know how to get along.
They got
to
get done with this impeachment first before they work on the
pig
private schools.
I own two of the largest.
I'm on pins and needles again.
Tits on my chest.
His name's Timothy, by the way.
His tits are named Tim and Timothy. Oh, the pig?
Is Patrick your middle name?
Patrick Timothy?
You don't know this, but...
Your real name, Timothy?
No, the pig's name. I give up.
Don't honestly. Fucking rename my pig.
Yeah.
It's Mervin.
His name is Mervin.
Yeah, back to pigs. Yeah.
Shut up.
Yeah,
he's got an Instagram. Yeah. It's That So Mervin.
Correct.
Follow him on there.
Keep talking about the pigs. Definitely.
He's beautiful.
That's right. Back to pigs. Okay.
You can make up a fucking pig, but I can't.
I have no. We're not making it up. I got a pig.
I'm so glad that we got off on.
He's my son.
Yeah. They almost found out my real name.
Your son?
Yeah, he's a little black pig.
Go on Instagram. Go on Instagram right now.
That's so Mervin.
Fucked a pig and made a pig. Excuse me.
Hey, my business is my business.
Whatever you do,
make America. Actually,
I'm totally trying.
I like fishes because they're so delicious.
Gotta go pigging.
Yeah, go to.
I like that
so
we
Mervin.
Totally just talked over whatever Mikey was trying to say. And that's how that happens. There we go. Now the show's totally over.
Great. Now everybody knows I didn't pay the bill for that.
You got a little divot for the cord.
Almost sure.
I like that. Look,
seriously. Yeah, I'm just trying to hear Mikey and George is talking about these goddamn fucking microphone squares.
Well, you put it on them. They're called flags. If you were in the business, how am I unsuccessful? What do you do during the? I don't come down to your job and eat the delicious tacos.
You're invited, man.
I know. That's what
you
hurts.
You still haven't been?
Yeah, because I can't have carbs.
Well, we already talked about it. You can do the cheese.
They do
the
a
cheese.
Lettuce wrap?
They do it like Taco Bell where they melt the cheese.
What night are you working? I'm coming.
All right.
Tomorrow night. Tonight. No, Thursday.
Are you working tomorrow?
No, I'm off until Sunday.
Sunday.
I got a friend coming in from L.A. Are you working
Steve?
Late?
Is
nah,
he coming
during
in?
The day.
First, yeah, Steve, call back in because I have to ask you a personal question.
I don't want Steve to come.
No, but we both did a 23andMe thing.
He's gonna do fucking heroin in our bathroom. I don't want Steve to come.
But neither one of us wanted to pay for a full 23andMe kit, so we combined our blood and mail.
I thought it was just supposed to be spit. They're gonna be real confused when blood shows up.
Yeah, it's some spit too. Can't be avoided, but there's blood. It's mostly blood. It's a soup. There's some piss, and I can't be sure, but shit.
Is it blood pudding?
Which is nice. Fuck you.
That's what I call my diarrhea. blood pudding.
And then you say, fuck you. Oh man, you're just gonna dump that shit.
Is
on
there
the
a is there a good restaurant that's Scottish that's in America?
Menigan's?
You don't want. Have you been to the UK?
Obviously not. You fuck.
You don't want their food. They're not known for their culinary. You know what I said? You know what I said to them? This is the real problem, and I don't know why I'm going over this because
so
I've
you just went to their country and just shit. Do you just shat?
I've
everything.
Been doing shows in the UK since 2009. I will just tell you this: it's beautiful. I love it. The people are great. Some food you can find good food now. They're catching on. And also American companies are going over. So like they're getting it. But like most of the food there is absolute dog shit. Do you know how you can
Mikey,
go,
how offensive
hold on,
is this?
No, he knows. This is nothing he hasn't been told.
That's why he's been to Five Guys
he's
twice.
He's not lying.
Listen to me.
So, no. Mikey, have you
I'm
you've
honest.
Been to America?
I have, yeah, how, twice. Did your, several times.
Did your dick hit your knee when you ate our food?
Does your chewing gum lose its flavor?
Yes and no. Yes in Vegas. No in New York. Fuck you, New York. Food was shit.
Vegas,
did you have
good.
Pizza in New York?
Yes, and it was fucking terrible because I've had pizza.
Oh, I took Mikey to Hash House to go-go.
No, I've had pizza in Italy, and it was fucking way better than New York.
I mean, I'd hope so.
Mikey came over for Super Bowl Sunday last year. We were at Atomic.
Who did he root? Who did you root for?
Eagles.
He won. He won a ton of money.
The Philly Eagles?
No, it was the overtime game.
Oh, nice.
With the
that's my team. That's my jam.
So you rooted for the team that once they won. The fans ran around their own town, and then one of them ate horse shit.
Yeah.
I'd eat horse shit for a potato.
Yes, apparently.
What did you just say?
I'd eat horse shit for a potato.
They had to grease up all the telephone poles just to collect the minority.
No, I rooted for the underdog.
Your eyebrows?
Because I need
you root for the underdog?
Yeah, because like, I knew that the Patriots were fucking going to win it, so I went, yeah, fuck it, I'll bet on the Eagles.
You put money on it?
And yeah.
What'd you win?
About 200 odd pounds.
200 quid? You trying to sound like it? Sounded like someone just put a finger in your butthole.
200 quid?
About almost 300 pounds.
300
pounds?
What is that like?
$450.
$450?
$450,
yeah.
Wow.
Their
food's
shit. The dollar's
strong. Yeah.
The food's shit. Like, most of their shit is bland. Okay, here's the main thing. You can go into almost any bar in town. Like, let's say you just go into a bar that's, like, okay, decent, whatever, random. And order a burger there or chicken wings there or whatever there. It'd be decent, right? Like, you just assume that. It'd be good. Right?
Get on with it.
Most places. You can't count on that there. Like, that's not like to go into a pub that has a good burger is hard to do.
You're just running on the fact that you're probably already drunk.
They're just grinding up leprechauns and horse meat. Like that, it's garbage, dude. Like it's so bad, bro.
But you can't will just, not deny that I'm there so are sad. Certain places that like, you can find that are fucking phenomenal.
Yeah, you can find great places, but you know those guys like smuggled in a recipe or something. I don't know.
Are they Mexican?
Like it's insane that like they've seen good food and refused to put salt on things.
How many Mexican restaurants are out there?
7. There's a good burrito. There's a good burrito place in Edinburgh called Bonnie Burrito, and it's fucking bomb.
Okay. Shout out to Bonnie.
I agree with that.
It's on South Clerk Street. Shout out to my South Clerk homies.
God damn.
Google Maps.
Dude, I
over
live
here.
There for a month every year, yeah, so I that's know true. The spots.
Oh, for the fringe.
You know? Yeah.
It just breaks my heart that you guys suck at food.
Yeah, they're awful.
Nope,
they
don't personally.
Know. They're good at rugby, right? Aren't you guys good at rugby?
No, they're all pussies. Have you seen rugby? It's like foosball for kids.
You know what I saw recently?
A gay person?
Yeah.
They're out now.
I saw that. Heard about it. Handball. Have you guys seen handball? I'm not talking about jerking off, which you do with that TV behind you.
Born to handball.
It's not volleyball.
Handball is like lacrosse without the stick. You just hold the ball. And just run up and down. And
masturbation is like lacrosse without the stick.
The goalies.
As someone who's Scottish, what the fuck is lacrosse? Because I don't know what the fuck that is.
Oh, isn't that our native people?
No,
our native
people
make it.
That's a fucking. I don't
so you do know what it is. You
yeah,
just
but
lied
do
to
you know?
Us?
Do you know what's crazy though, Mikey? Mikey,
thing that you throw a ball in. I have no fucking.
Mikey,
clue.
Do you know what's crazy though? Tyler doesn't know what netball is.
I think it's crazy that Mikey's hammered at 8:30 in the morning.
He's Scottish. And he's an alcoholic. And he's a chronic. Like, he's covering
I just
up.
Didn't,
Mikey, how old are you?
I didn't think.
No and no and no.
Mikey, between you and I, we're having a talk later.
You and me. Hey, Mikey, how old
this,
are you?
This means you need an intervention. And I don't want to ruin a good time we're having right now. But you have some problems. And we're going to
talk
about
it. I feel like you're 35. Mikey, you're 35, right?
He's 32.
32.
Yep.
You walk Spot. Around.
32.
Walk. Oh, not oh, 32. Nice.
Look, I care about him because he's a friend, but this is a, you know.
A bit much.
This is a red flag. And if, by the way, if there's a woman in your life, she needs to run.
They always do.
No, I was talking to Tyler.
He sounds like he's 45, but I picture just a young, vibrant soul.
He's Scottish, so it's over. You know what I mean? He's 32. He's single. It's like get a cat and a Prius. Call it a day.
Do they have Priuses in Scotland?
No. There's too many hills.
They can't take the hill?
Yeah, they need 4x4s, right?
He's actually not wrong.
Yeah.
We can't do it.
I know, baby.
Yeah.
They mostly ride sheep.
That's what pull the buggy?
Like sleigh dogs? Like sleigh dogs?
If you
dogs.
Order an Uber...
Everyone just pretends to be...
I just said
their Uber
Santa.
There is actually called Uber.
That's Aberdeen.
First, shut up. You know that could win the best joke of the French.
No. Well, actually, it probably could.
Yeah.
That's sad.
Yeah. Trademark that. Today is... What's today? The 19th. December 19th.
Yep.
Same 12, day 19, as Pearl 19. Harbor. If you subtract 12 days.
So Pearl Look. Harbor is a day that will live in infamy. It's when the Japanese bombed.
Why
our...
do you keep explaining everything?
Because we got a lot of Scottish fans watching
it is
right now.
Like
they know.
Reading
do
Wikipedia.
They,
I actually know about Pearl Harbor. I did history in school. So.
I know about pearl necklaces.
Thanks.
I'm talking about your childhood.
Hey, stop.
I you... earned that bicycle.
Do you know the states? If I gave you a map of the U.S.
State? Oh, yeah, I could probably do that.
Dang, I don't even know.
That was confidence.
Yeah.
Mikey has a U.S. fiance.
I got 48 of 50.
A Boston fiance.
Oh, Boston? Oh, so you're a Celtics fan?
Packers.
Oh, shit. Okay, why? Because they're green?
Yep.
Yeah, that's why I picked the Eagles.
She's from there.
Oh, she's from Wisconsin? So
Wisconsin.
She's like... Hey, babe, it's in Wisconsin.
Also, he really likes cheese.
He does?
Cheese, man.
You like brie?
No. I fucking hate cheese, honestly.
Oh, damn. That's racist.
It's not racist. It's
all I do is try to make Tyler laugh, and I get like one out of every three, and I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. It's he good. Gets it.
Will you, before we get out of here, because God knows this will be edited down to a tight 20 minute show, what do we have to do to get Mervin in here?
Be okay with him pissing and or shitting on your
floor? I'm fine with any of that.
Cool.
He pissed so much the other day. Dude, all twice. Over the living room, yeah.
He just walked across the living room, corner to corner, and peed. He didn't stop.
Can you bring him over like right after he pees?
Yeah.
What if we just keep him in a bucket?
He'll throw a fit.
Do they make some sort of pig swine,
bucket? A pucket?
Swine diaper? Swiper?
Swiper, no swipey?
Or did I just get us on Shark Tank?
I don't know, because his dick is where your belly, where his like most belly buttons are.
I wish his dick was where my belly button is.
Well, we can work it out. There'll be a fee for sure.
Oh, goddamn stud fee.
Yeah.
First of all, I could not give you money to let your pig pump my belly button full of cum.
I couldn't do it for free. So.
So let's just get it straight. I'd feel like I was still winning.
As long as that's how you feel.
Oh, tit God. For tat. Just imagine sleeping with it running down your leg.
Mikey.
Yes.
Help us.
Yeah, how much would you pay? I'd
love to try. Was your over under on pig?
No, I would really like to get the pig in the studio for the show. It'd be amazing.
My over under on which?
What would you pay? Like, what's your on pig jizz running down your belly button to your knee?
Oh, no good, really. Minus.
Will you fucking bend around? I don't look all over your cameras and like, well, how's your show work? And then edit your videos poorly.
I love. By the way, go check out Two Fingers Neat Show on Instagram and Facebook see Patrick Melton.
It is a really fun show to do. They do a show called Two Fingers Neat. Soon, George will be leaving it, so I can only imagine it'll get better. it'll be great. I think you should check. Who are you going to replace George with?
We don't know yet.
Another random minority.
We don't know yet. We're going to do some.
Could I audition?
We're going to do some auditions for sure.
When are you leaving?
May.
Oh, I'll be back. So I get back in April. I leave again in July.
I mean, that's going to be a problem.
No, we'll do them over Skype. We'll have Mikey set it all up.
Mikey, we're going to need you, bud.
Vegas and gin.
What if I bring you?
He'll send you bottles.
On the road.
You bring me.
Two fingers need on the road. Ooh. What if we got... Look, Mikey... I go to Scotland to do comedy every year. You're a comedian. What if I got... chicken and... A Two Fingers Neat comedy tour.
Done.
Over to Scotland.
I like it.
I don't know how much you make in your day job, but I probably got it on me.
Sure.
We nail this whole thing down.
Let's get it on paper and I'll see.
No, you have a good job where they might let you off for something like that.
Possibly.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not talking to you.
Oh.
You're the basis of this whole thing, Mikey.
You're an alcoholic and you're on the brink of being fired.
You think right now you'd get
futuristic and you should probably.
Well, you're the one on here going glug glug 8 a.m.
I didn't actually. You're the one.
Just said it.
You've just said it twice. And by the way, when I get done editing all this, you'll be saying a lot of shit.
By the way, it was him and not me. I completely sound of reason.
Mikey.
By the way, that's why.
Mikey, did you earlier?
Nope, you did. I've never. We'll talk about this later.
he's smarter than you thought.
Hold on. You would never.
I've never company name on air, by the way. That's.
You just instantly play that shit.
Hold on, real quick. What do you think about What do you think about doers?
Really, fucking stop talking about this because I've never said anything on air.
What do you think about
to you in personal text?
Well, you know what? When you're drowning, you should panic.
Stop talking. Like, this cannot go out. By the way,
what do you think about?
I'm being fucking. Like, I'm being fucking real. Serious now, Patrick. This cannot go out. You fucking ruined this whole thing. I will text you right now. Like, you have fucked this whole fucking thing. Or at least the last 10 minutes.
Oh, did we ruin the Two Fingers Neat tour to Edinburgh? Oh no.
Like, really?
I wanted to go to Edinburgh.
Mikey, I've been against him saying all that stuff this whole time.
No, we
amazing company.
They're shit.
I don't know if you have anything to do with them.
They are the worst.
I don't know, but I've always been a big fan of everything. Does they do a lot of big bartender competitions here in Vegas? It's awesome.
More like
wasn't he the
no
fuck really? Ah, you know what? It's Christmas. Fuck it.
Are you just saying you're gonna take another shot?
It's almost Christmas.
Like a shot.
Mikey, by acting like that, all you do is make it a big deal. Don't worry. When I edit this out, you'll work for a company called Chucky Charles.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah,
Charles Edward Chucky. Whatever. Kids pizza place where they for kids that want to be NBA.
Just don't.
Shut up. Just shut up.
Okay. You made that thing.
You are so drunk at 9 a.m.
I'm 2 hours awake at 9 a.m.
Which is a feat.
Right. It's too early to be that
drunk.
Right.
I applaud you.
He had to have gone to bed drunk.
Do you have an alarm clock that just pours shots into your mouth? And you wake up because of you're drowning?
I'm sorry. Do Americans just not understand Scottish linguistics? Is that what the thing is?
I think it's arrogant to think that Americans understand anything.
Right. How dare you?
Yeah.
Good point, Tyler. How dare he?
Yeah. Way to
How dare assume. You assume we're knowledgeable? You've seen the stereotypes about us. We're all fat and we're fanny packs. Bum bags, as you call them.
Oh my god,
for real. You just don't understand, you know, the shit that we're talking.
Oh, are we talking shit now?
Oh, are we slanging shit?
Let me tell you something. Tours off.
Call that. Now, yeah, I'm gonna text you, I think. I'm kind of scared about what I just said.
Shut your mouth.
I just like that you're talking in cursive.
Oh, God. How dare you use a heckler line on my podcast?
I liked it.
Ugh, good. I'm sorry. We don't usually do that kind of thing, Mikey. I'm sorry you had to hear that.
Anyway, Patrick, while I'm here, Merry Christmas, because I don't think we'll talk until next
year?
Christmas.
Oh, my God.
Until next Christmas?
Have a happy Christmas.
Oh, no, we're talking before Christmas.
Are we?
Oh, yeah. Set up a call. Put it in your calendar. Hey, call my secretary.
What day? Let's start this.
Valentine's.
What were you just hitting?
Yeah.
Hey, is domestic abuse a thing?
Put your girlfriend on the phone.
We need to verify her safety and well-being.
Blink if you're in and you're hurting her.
What does she think about you drinking this early?
Well,
she's not a fan.
I'm not. God. Firstly, this doesn't exist, and secondly, it doesn't exist.
It sounds like the lead singer of Oasis. It's crazy.
I think he just saw Magic Trick. Are there suicide hotlines there you can call, or do you have to call a U.S. one?
I bet he's got...
I guess it's too late. Mikey, come on. Buddy, wake up. You know, it's 9 a.m. Rise and shine.
It's 10 a.m.
Well, you know.
We're
all just looking at a sundial.
I don't get this.
What was that?
Don't fucking start that.
What?
I will fucking annoy you.
Okay, well, stay on the line. Police are on their way.
You see, oh.
I'd like to do a wellness check.
I hate this.
I would love to.
You know, whatever, you do your fucking thing.
All right, we'll be right over.
Sure.
Leave the door unlocked and the bullets out of the gun.
I'm done. Honestly, I'm done.
I know that's what we're worried about. So no, sit tight. How many fingers am I sticking up your asshole?
How many do you want?
Damn, two fingers.
I mean,
two fingers. Neat.
Neat?
Ooh. I like that he's accommodating.
Yeah. He's a very good sport. Yeah,
it's Mike,
good
yeah, I'm a like big fan.
Into
man.
My moves. I like that.
Yeah. You're a fresh bit of air.
In this. All right, Mikey. You and I are going to talk tomorrow or today.
Later.
So hang on until then, all right? Don't give in to the virus. Stay strong, brother. Solidarity.
Hey, Mikey, are you watching us while you talk to us? Did he hang up?
I'm scared.
I think he died.
He said he was done.
Mikey?
Call him. Call him.
Hey, Mikey? Mikey? Little buddy? Did you... Hey, Mikey?
Are you there?
It says we're still connected.
Quit messing around.
I'd like to rap about you if I could. This song is for my friend Mikey. It's how we're going to end the show today. Before we leave, Tyler Jolley, everybody, has been fucking amazing. You know, he acts like a low-energy guy with no material.
Thank you.
That's right. That's a sweet spot. You know, he fits in. And he nails it. Like, a lot of guys couldn't hit that groove. But you nail it.
Thank you.
You make it look effortless to put no effort into something. If that makes sense.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Yeah. And where can people, what do you want to, anything? You have Two Fingers Neat, of course, with George.
The Two Fingers Neat Show, Odd Men Out podcast, and Childhood Hero podcast.
Which has had an interesting history.
Why?
Everybody has a childhood.
Yeah. But yeah, look those up.
Don't worry, we'll edit it. And where can people ignore your accounts?
TylerJollyComedy.com has a link to everything.
Do you like that go or is it too much?
I fucking hate it. Okay. I hate it more than Mikey hates you right now.
What about a subtle one like that?
I like it. That's better.
Okay.
It feels like we're, you know, like there's a lot of people here listening to us. So, yeah. TylerJollyComedy.com.
TylerJollyComedy.com.
Yep.
And
this is George.
He's allowed to do 2/3 of a plug.
It's 5/8.
Why do you keep telling me George's name? Like, I don't know George.
Because you said George.
He was thinking
because
of the
I was thinking of the 2/3 joke. That's a funny joke.
I thought it was
three-fifths.
Three-fifths.
Yeah, close enough.
I don't know the fraction.
Get your
I was against
get your
the whole thing.
Down. Get your racism down.
I voted no. So, sorry, I don't know. The numbers of the opposing team's proposal.
It's called history.
Yeah, I wish it wasn't. And also, Trump's in office now, so is it?
Did he change history?
Trump, yeah.
I mean,
not yet. Before him, you stay on your toes.
He will.
And you stay off yours.
I'm on pins.
No, what do you... Do you have anything you'd like to...
Social media? Can I get like, the full... Can I get the full effect?
You want the... You want more?
Yeah, why is it just us?
I don't want that baby back bullshit. Tyler Jolley bullshit. Niggas be running up in the streets.
Hey, rap for him.
Rap? I need a beat. Give me that beat.
No, you don't.
Give me that hot shit. Boys coming up to the backyard. Patrick Mel.
Is that a rap?
I need a beat. I can't just rap.
No one has ever done that.
I need a beat. Give me the beat.
All right, we can do it.
You got it?
All right. Mikey hung up, which is really mean.
Is your agency using WordPress to build websites?
There you go, dog. Hands off. Go ahead. Freestyle. If you can't do it to this, you can't do it to shit.
Is there a lot of people skip?
Yeah, of course there is. But if you were good, you could do it to this.
I'm going to like WordPress. Instead, work with
Duda. We're just plugging WordPress.
Platform that's
first of all,
to help
WordPress
runs
like one-fifth of the internet.
So stop working with the wrong tools and say...
If your website's not on WordPress, you're a fucking idiot.
Oh, wow.
What do you use? Libsyn?
Squarespace?
Cool. No, they're good. And he's done.
I know.
I mean, I get it. You have to... Have
Nobuna.com is a great way to get the best premium plugins for WordPress and WooCommerce.
Guys, I make a lot of money.
You can visit Nobuna.com and learn more now.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Hold on. I meant for this to be an ad. Let me go back.
Yeah.
Yo,
what's up?
Yeah.
Check the track. My name is George White, and I'm sitting in the club, sipping on this yak. Yeah. Boy Alex Ansel, sitting in his bed, all fat as fuck. Nigga so fat. Nigga so fat. Nigga so fat. Patrick Mellon told me not to say nigga on the air, but I'm gonna drop it cause I don't give a fuck. Nigga so fat. Where we going with this? I don't even know. Sitting in Las Vegas cause all the dope hip hop artists die in Las Vegas. Getting gunned down in Las Vegas. Tyler Jolley Las Vegas. Nigga so fat. When we gonna eat his pig? Cook that motherfucker up. Put it on the grill. Nigga eating buttercups. Reese's peanut butter buttercups.
I'm just surprised that you rhymed.
Special occasion. This one goes out to my boy Mikey. Nigga, I hope you don't get fired. I love you. But you a motherfucking piece of shit. And I'm done.
Yep. That was a pretty good crash and burn.
I instantly lost interest.
I liked it.
My ADD kicked in. Oh, see, that's why I was waiting for the beat to drop.
Oh, that's what messed you up.
Oh, yeah.
But it went two extra
why
bars.
Is, can you turn the echo off?
No, that's how the rhyme sounds.
I'm about to clap.
It sounded better.
I'm about to clap back.
Yes.
Oh, you about to drop a rhyme?
Yeah, goddammit, nigga. You know I'm finna drop. You know I'm finna drop some shit. Yeah. Welcome to church. Y'all think y'all know me? Y'all don't even know.
The Al Pastor is in.
Fuck yeah, it's getting cold out there this Christmas. I see a lot of motherfuckers' tears running down a lot of motherfuckers' cheeks. freezing, boy. They hit a lot of motherfuckers' lips. And I'll tell you one other thing, motherfucker. I got chef lips, and I'm coming for you, bitch. Preach. This is my story. Yo, my name is Patrick. I do a podcast. I talk real quick. I talk real fast. I get on stage. I like to blow smoke. I like to talk to girls. I like to snort coke. I like to ride up with my friends. I like to hang out in my Benz. Cruising down Las Vegas Boulevard. Eating all kinds of food, full of lard. I'm always just kicking back with my friends Tyler here and George, what's his name again? I can't remember shit, I'm like a losing it. I like to think that I could be something. One day I might reach for the stars, fall on my face, get lots of scars, eat lots of pizza, eat lots of bars of fucking Xanax, go straight to Mars, sleeping on a pillow, calling all the cars, tell them come to pick me up, I'm at the bars, can't drive home cause I've been sipping on lean, gotta go to sleep so I can't do it all again, goddamn, I'm a motherfucking fiend, I smoke so much weed, I just gotta get my lean on, sleeping on cars and doing on stage, dropping fucking shit all over this page, traveling from Australia, back to the US, over to Edinburgh, Scotland. Mikey better kill himself. He lost his fucking job today. We told his fucking boss what he does. And oh God, yay, it's too much shit. You do too much shit. They're gonna find out about it. You're gonna lose your goddamn job. And that's not cool, dog. You gotta get your shit together. This is an intervention. We're reaching out. Preach. Love. Church. All these motherfuckers. You don't even know. I had a friend who killed himself because he ran out of Milky Ways. That's no way to live. That's no way to talk to your friends. You got friends. They can help you. Just because your bong's empty doesn't mean there's not a whole grinder full of more weed. Just repack it and then call your friends up. Tell them come over. Have a bong. Life is too short to live that way. And that's why I gotta say, I'm stepping on cords and shit. I don't care, but it did fuck everything up. This one's to my kids. I'm sorry, your daddy was a loser. He sat in a room talking podcasts like a boozer. I couldn't do shit, so I gave up easy. I hung out with people like Jeezy and fucking Teezy. I gotta go outside a little later. Check on my car cause I parked in a bad neighborhood. I gotta move it cause it's probably gonna be towed if I don't pay a parking fee. Honestly, my registration expired. So I do. I need to go get that.
Sorry to hear that.
Now it'll be your, and now you'll do a clap back.
Clap back. Schlapp on my nah. Corn on the cow.
Your own check song.
Cut the reverb.
Oh, thanks. I wish I would have thought of that. Yeah. It was done like 3 seconds ago. Idiot. He's lagging.
What an idiot.
What a fucking...
Pencil shavings?
Don't bring him again.
What's you in said your, for both of us.
I did.
What's in your thing?
Well, I thought you would balance. Again, everything needs a balance.
A yin and a yang. Umami.
And I think,
we're, yeah, I think we're the perfect
you guys
umami.
Give each other that.
That was dope, dude. I feel like you got an album.
Oh, I do. I have several. But most of them are saxophones.
You should hit up Victor Oladipo and be on his track. You could rap over his shit.
I don't know who that is.
He plays basketball for the Pacers. He was just on Masked Singer. He was thingamajig.
You talked about Masked Singer. You were here last time, and I really tried to get into it.
Dude, I'm telling
but
you.
But then I saw Ken Jeong talking about it or something.
Ken Jeong.
That's what I said.
Yeah, he said Kim.
No, I didn't.
All right.
Instant replay. Run it back. Run it back. You can't brag about the service and then not do it.
He just wants to see you play with your fucking
electronics. That's all.
Yeah, I didn't subscribe to it.
George is that kid in Radio Shack that just fucking touched his dick way too much.
I was wondering where that kid went.
Yeah, they kicked him out. They kicked him out. Let me back in.
Oh God!
Where's
and now
the
we
replay?
Have a now we have a guy from London in the chat.
Uh oh,
we're waking up
fucking
Europe.
Worldwide.
We're waking well because that's what time it is.
Yeah,
I mean, you were supposed to be home hours ago.
I know.
Now we're going to have to explain.
You're ruining my fucking relationship.
What time do you usually go to sleep, Patrick?
I'm going to be honest.
I don't sleep.
I was very impressed. I didn't think you had that in you.
Don't be, because
it was probably pre-written.
I'm the best fucking comedian you've ever met, and I don't even try.
I didn't say
so
you
why don't you
funny.
Back down?
I didn't say
this
you weren't
This is the
funny.
Second time
Rapping
with the where,
not
why
being
are
funny.
You successful in the fucking, wow, I really didn't think you had it in you. I have it in me and more.
Do you
I'll
rap?
Run circles around
They're
you.
Called
Do
fucking
you rap on
compliments.
Stage?
Oh, guess what? Your tires, they're already popped.
Do you rap on stage?
No.
That's your closing bit?
I think rap is for faggots.
You just rapped.
This show got all kinds of gay.
No, I don't rap. It's
that's your closing bit for your merch table.
It's for my merch table
to send people to your merch table. Yeah,
please
check out my merch.
I tell people please not to go to my merch table. That gets them over. I'm like, so you stay away from my merch table. I don't have any shirts.
Do you
and
sell?
They come over. They're like shirts.
Is it all Nobody Likes Onion swag?
Yeah, mostly. I have like I do
coasters,
cocktail napkins with my logo. I sell.
Do you think Mikey's still friends with you?
No. I got several texts to the contrary. Let's see what he said.
Screen.
Mikey, if we're not friends, text me now. If we are friends, text me in 2 minutes. It's a surefire way to know.
Yeah. How well the service is between here and Scotland.
Yeah. Also, I don't think he knows how to text.
Do they have that out there?
No, not yet.
Does he have to go to Five Guys to get texts?
Yes. What a dumb question.
What's like a big other than Scotch, what's their big export?
Potatoes?
Me.
You're not from there.
Kilts.
Actually, I am.
Mel Gibson.
Prove it.
Blue
I don't,
face
they're
paint.
Big export. They don't export anything. Kilts, fucking tartan patterns. awful Scottish trad music.
Can you cut just you doing whatever that sound was and just that? Yeah.
Hit the reverb on this shit.
You know what you sound like?
I don't care for that.
Oh my god!
It's like when the stuff comes out of his mouth on Green Mile.
Oh.
Oh, the bees.
Yeah, whatever those were.
Are they bees?
I thought they were mosquitoes.
I thought it was just flies.
I thought they were sort of hibiscus.
It was
larva.
Probably the sickness. I think it's the sickness.
Coming down with the sickness.
Oh yeah, I love that stuff. Disturbed is a great band, and you can see them on our show every Thursday right here.
I didn't know that. I didn't know you were on that level.
Well, we got them. So next time you think I can't get Disturbed, why don't you watch your goddamn mouth? Keep my name out of your mouth. I love people who say that. Keep my name out of your mouth. Then I just print it a ton and eat it.
And fax it to him?
No, we shut that down. Circa 2017.
Are people still watching this?
No. My internet went out hours ago.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. No, I thought we'd end on the big rap thing, but then you kept talking.
I'm sorry.
We were all supposed to just get up quietly, put our headphones down, and walk away.
Yeah.
I thought it would bomb, frankly.
He does that.
Yeah, no, it went really well. That rap battle was the greatest.
Yeah, no. When
is it only available
when
in
I tell people about this? I'll tell them like I saved a plane full of people.
I'm gonna tell my kids it was Nick Cannon versus Eminem.
Oh well, there we go.
They do have two albums together. Well, Mikey hasn't texted me, so I can only assume he did do it and put the gun in his nephew.
Rip.
Wait, how can I call him back?
I gotta pee.
Well, that's not available. All right, well, we'll wrap it up. Thank you, everybody, for listening. We've had a great Christmas with you all. Anything you guys want to say before we depart? Because you've really been, you know, it's been one of the best times.
I don't know how many people are saying this, but Black Lives Matter.
Well, a lot of people are saying it. Guys, we're going to leave you with a song.
Thank
by...
you for coming in. Patrick Melton, appreciate it.
Yeah, we're glad to have you, man.
Oh, thank you.
You know.
No, I really appreciate both of you guys coming in. It was a late night thing.
We thought it was going to be better.
Yeah, we all, you know, it's a roll of the dice with all these things. It's Vegas, after all. Yeah, no. So, you know, either we all feel bad.
Next time, don't
it.
Wear that hat. Sorry.
I agree.
But it's just a problem with our sponsors. You know,
this hat?
Yeah. Our sponsors.
Oh,
we're
no.
Have to
hold,
blur
on,
this
hold,
whole
on,
time.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. I was ready to end, but if there's something we can make right here, I would love to do that. Who's the sponsor and what do I have to say? Right.
Touché.
Yeah.
Isn't that Scottish for...
Yeah. What do I need? Look, guys.
I got to pee.
You dug a hole with this new bit. I was wrapping
up.
I had the logo ready to go and you were like...
The logo back up.
You were like, we have a big problem with the sponsor and I halted production. Okay. We do have an empty bottle here.
There we go.
Where did that come from?
It's Dewars.
I'm a drinker. The point is, it's a sight gag.
It's a
decoy. Play. Yeah. Don't worry about it. Okay, we're going to be out of here, but apologies. You know, I didn't mean anything by it. And a lot of people are, it happens to a lot of guys. Okay, bye, everybody. On behalf of Tyler Jolley, George White, thank you for coming. You were so much well-behaved tonight. And, you know, between the two of you, you really, I want to say this, like, to both of you, I really can't thank you enough for coming in. Like, it means a lot. And
anytime.
And the real winners are the children. But I saw tonight, like, well, I appreciate it if you don't, you know, cheapen it. I saw tonight the talented one. You know, I saw the other one, the dead weight, and it really made me thankful. So thank you guys.
You're welcome.
Anytime.
And the dynamic you've displayed here of like one worthless, useless sack of shit versus one dynamic, bold, prolific performer.
We know.
Fuck, you know. I'm going to leave you with Josh Gad performing When I Am Older from Frozen 2.
What was that? Samantha?